For the third and final time this weekend, the Carolina Thunderbirds and the Delaware Thunder come together to find a winner of the three-game series, both teams splitting a game apiece, and they'll do it in a bit of unique circumstances. The snow and ice pouring from the Winston-Salem sky right now, and so in all of this, in our somewhat warm little arena here, the Thunderbirds and Thunder will try to find a victor here on a Sunday afternoon. Hello, everybody. My name is Dylan Clark. Thanks so much for being with us. We are a bit short-staffed this afternoon, so we're trying to make things work as best we can. So bear with us here from the technical side. Carolina entering this game, fifth place in the FPHL. 10 regulation wins to their credit so far. The Delaware Thunder, one regulation win. They are trying to claw their way back up the FPHL standings. These two teams split the series so far, I should say. A 6-5 overtime win Friday night for the Delaware Thunder. They found themselves out to a 4-0 lead. The Thunderbirds came back, took the lead, 5-4. And then later on, a late overtime, or a tying goal would send the game to overtime. Alex Basie would squeak one between the wickets of Jacob Caffrey, get Delaware just its second win of the season. First one in the overtime frame. The Thunderbirds resilient and a bit angered at that fact. Came back here, a 4-1 victory last night. Gus Ford continues his point streak to 13 games. Astronomical point totals there. And the festivities would continue. Alex Basie and John Batita would get into a bit of a scrap, to say the least. Both of those two were ejected from the game. Batita for spearing, Basie for fighting. Basie's been suspended for his part in the altercation, grabbing Batita from behind, punching him in the back of the head as he was down on the ice. John Batita is good to go tonight for the Carolina Thunderbirds, and that is good news there. Leading the team in assists and points, Thunderbird captain 34 points on the season. None better in a Carolina sweater. It looks to be Chris Paulin in goal tonight. We will get confirmation on that for you when we have it available. And we've got all kinds of stuff coming up. We caught up with, well, one of the Thunderbird forwards talking about, again, the unique situation of tonight's contest, the history between these two teams, and how all of that is shaping up together as we head into the third matchup on the weekend. Sixth matchup of the season between these two teams, and they've still got another weekend set later on in the calendar. We'll send you a quick commercial break, and when we come back, we'll send you that player interview.
Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist helps you do more of the things you love. More laughs, more adventures, more hugs. We combine the brightest minds in medicine to bring you world-class care with a commitment to strengthen the health and wellness of our community. Because when it comes to the health of you and your family, no one should settle for anything short of life-changing.
Conveniently located at the corner of Rinalda Road and Northwest Boulevard, Salem Smiles and Dr. Sarah C. Schoaf is the preferred orthodontist of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Dr. Schoaf is a Winston-Salem native and a trusted name in orthodontics since 1992. So whether you're on the ice or in the stands, trust your teeth to Dr. Smashmouth and her team at Salem Smiles.
Want to get in on the action? Bring your friends. With group packages of 12 seats or more, tickets start at just $12 a person. Group packages are perfect for church groups, youth groups, business outings, and more. Come together to see your Thunderbirds. Call 336-748-3949 today.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So, we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
Family owned and operated since 1938, Mustin and Crutchfield Food Market in Kernersville is the place to find your favorite homemade foods. Sample the finest cuts of meat from our on-site butcher, enjoy a glass bottle of soda like the old days, and go home with a tub.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem as we continue with Thunderbirds pregame here. Jacob Schnapp has kind of taken Carolina by storm after joining about a couple of weeks into the season here. Scored two goals in his Carolina debut with the against the Columbus River Dragons, I should say. And he's been one of Carolina's most prolific scorers, third on the team in scoring right now. We caught up with Schnapp earlier this afternoon, talk about some of his success and the interesting dynamics of the weekend series and what he and his team expect out of the Delaware Thunder. Here's Jacob Schnapp.
Welcome back to Thunderbirds pregame. Dylan Clark with Carolina forward Jacob Schnapp. And Jacob, big win last night, 4-1, and it came after an emotional game, overtime loss on Friday night. How much did the emotions of Friday night influence you guys last night?
Definitely a lot. You hate to drop a game like that to a team like that. And then, I mean, we knew what we needed to do. In the third period of that Friday night game, we were all over them. We just couldn't get the job done in overtime. But coming into last night's game, we knew we needed a big win.
Did you have that same feeling that you felt third period Friday night? Is that kind of how all of last night felt?
100%, yeah. Third period, every single period.
And with the physicality in that game, you know, early on, the tensions were still high first period last night. And after the Basie and Batita altercation, things kind of settled down from there. Did that surprise you, or did you expect things to kind of keep going the animosity way?
Honestly, I thought everything was going to keep going. I definitely wouldn't be surprised if they come out flying tonight looking to get after it with us. But the boys just need to keep our cool heads and just roll over them tonight.
Is that what you know, when you look at the approach to this game from the opposition, do you just need to stick to the game plan from last night, or do you need to kind of dig even deeper tonight?
Dig a little bit deeper, but definitely stick to the same game plan we had last night. It worked out, and just keep it rolling there.
Jacob, thanks as always for the time. Good luck tonight. That was Jacob Schnapp. We'll take a quick break, and when we come back, more Thunderbirds pregame.
Welcome back inside the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex as we get set for Thunderbirds and Thunder here. Third and final game on the weekend, Sunday afternoon. And those of you, we welcome you
listening on the Thunderbirds Radio Network, and those of you watching on Thunderbirds TV, do apologize there. You got to look at my smirk there, post-interview face, whatever you want to call it, for about 2 minutes. I do apologize for that. But as we get into the game here, Carolina and Delaware, the Thunderbirds 6-0-0-1 all time against the Delaware Thunder. Friday night's overtime loss, the first time the Thunder have beaten the Carolina Thunderbirds in their brief history. Again, Delaware just entered the league in the 2019-2020 season, which was cut short. They only found themselves matched up against Carolina twice that season to that point. And so a brief history between these two teams. And Carolina in this season series, 4 wins and 1 overtime loss. So Delaware is a squad against whom the Carolina Thunderbirds have had success against. But Friday night's game is a perfect example of why you can never count an opponent out. Because again, Delaware, last place in the FPHL. Just one regulation win on the season, a .091 points percentage. They're far behind the pack there. But again, Carolina is now on the short list of teams that the Thunder have beaten. And it's a black mark, if you will, on their record this season. And so Delaware, again, doesn't matter where they are in the standings, doesn't matter their record. They've still got some offensive weapons that can hurt you. And they had one offensive weapon that hurt the Thunderbirds consistently on Friday night and again once on Saturday night, and that is Ryan Marker. 18 goals, 18 assists, 36 points on the season, a goal and 4 assists on Friday night. Again, he had a hand in 5 of 6 Delaware goals on that road game there for Carolina. He was contained a bit more last night, limited to just 1 goal. But again, on that goal, you could see why Ryan Marker is the way he is and why he's able to have so much success offensively. Uses his speed, uses his size to his advantage, unlike many players in the FPHL do, to a degree that many players in the FPHL cannot do. Utilized his patience, and on that goal, kind of a partial breakaway, the little fake shot freezes Chris Paulin. Marker goes around for the wraparound. Easy goal there for him. 1-0 Delaware to that point, and the Thunderbirds in their crowd a bit on their heels, a bit tentative at that point. Like, oh, okay, well, what's going to happen here? This team has already won in overtime last night. What's going to happen here? But the Thunderbirds able to settle in last night. But that goal right there is perhaps a perfect example of why Marker has been so dangerous for the Thunder this season and in seasons previous as well. His ability to read plays, his knowledge of the opposition. He knows Chris Paulin's an aggressive goaltender. He knows that Chris Paulin is going to come out and try to poke check there. He did so, and Marker able to slip around him for that wraparound goal. 1-0 Delaware to that point. And for the Thunder, some players out of the lineup. Alex Basie suspended again, as we remarked earlier on in the pregame show, for his antics there with John Batita. The fight cost him the game, or caused him to be ejected from the game, I should say, and a one-game suspension being served by Basie tonight. A number of injuries as well for Delaware. Liam Little was hurt last night. Yanni Liarakos hurt, won't be in the lineup. Ryan Swain hurt as well, and Noah Wild out of the lineup and unavailable for Delaware. It's some pretty considerable points that will be left on the shelf there for the Thunder without those players in the lineup. Particularly Yanni Liarakos, 6 goals and 18 assists for 24 points this season. He was second in scoring for the team. Played on Friday night, did not participate Saturday night. He won't play here on Sunday afternoon, and so that leaves Marker kind of a man all alone on an island. And the Thunder short-staffed, only 13 skaters tonight. So a short bench. The Thunderbirds will be certain to try and pounce all over them, and we believe starting in goal for the Thunder tonight will be Trevor Babin. 2-9 on the season, a 6.15 goals against, .882 save percentage. But for Babin, if you'll remember, 48 saves on 53 shots Friday afternoon in that overtime winner. He was a large part of the reason why the Thunderbirds had so much trouble in that game and why that game ended up going to overtime and was, in the end, a victory for the Delaware Thunder. Trevor Babin really stole the show there in Delaware 2 nights ago, and he looks to do the same again tonight. Right-handed catching goaltender for Delaware, and we will see what the matchup and the physicality with him is. If you'll remember, Babin came over during a media timeout and yanked off goaltender Jacob Caffrey's mask down in the Carolina zone, and those two exchanged some pleasantries. Some greetings of a Happy New Year, although I guess at this point in January it's a bit late for that. So
we'll keep an eye on that and see just what Babin has up his sleeve, goaltending or otherwise. And we'll send you to a quick break here on Thunderbirds pregame ahead of Part 3, Carolina-Delaware on this weekend. When we come back, we'll take a look inside the Thunderbirds roster, who we expect to start in goal, and a whole lot more coming your way on the Thunderbirds Hockey Network.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic. The Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, because these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or visit us at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street. Want to get in on the action? Bring your friends. With group packages of 12 seats or more, tickets start at just $12 a person. Group packages are perfect for church groups, youth groups, business outings, and more. Come together to see your Thunderbirds. Call 336-748-3949 today.
Sarah used 46%. Josh used 22%, then visited the dealership. Peter used it from beginning to end. Now there's a new way to experience the modern difference. It's called Go Modern, and it's car buying driven by you. Do as much or as little as you want, then visit the dealership and pick up right where you left off. No matter how much you use, Go Modern makes car buying 100% easy. Go Modern, the new way to...
Welcome back to Winston-Salem for Thunderbirds pregame here ahead of Carolina and Delaware, and not a ton of lineup changes for the Carolina Thunderbirds. Last night's contest, they did have some additions that helped immediately. Most notably, Devin Warfield and Everett Thompson, again, been players that have played primarily at home for the Carolina Thunderbirds. They come back into the lineup and immediate dividends there. Warfield didn't find his way onto the score sheet last night, but he's been an impact player for Carolina all season long. 4 goals and 4 assists for 8 points. He was a minute muncher last night on the ice a ton, especially in the third period. Had a couple of solid looks at the net. One puck just barely finding its way over the crossbar, not under it. Devin Warfield, his skating and his forechecking abilities, probably the most important part of his game, the most useful part of Warfield's game that really sets the tone against the opposition. And that's going to be even more important, and it will be even more on display against a Thunder team that's, again, pretty shorthanded tonight, just 13 skaters for Delaware. So the Thunderbirds will look to skate him into submission, and even if it may be even in the first and second periods, those third periods are always the telling signs of the conditioning of a team, or in this case, the shorthandedness of a team. And so if you're running around for a ton of time in the first and second periods, not likely to have a ton left in the gas tank when that third period rolls around. And then Everett Thompson, most likely and probably his best game of the season last night, kept his cool, scored a goal, found his way into another assist on a Gus Ford power play goal, and throwing the body around like there was no tomorrow. Again, Thompson, with that physical presence, it was something the Thunderbirds had been missing over the last stretch of games in his absence. Thompson immediately coming out, throwing the body around, making his presence known, and making the Thunder think twice about where they're going to skate away with the puck. So Everett Thompson, again, back in the lineup tonight for Carolina. He looks to be on a line with Warfield and Blake Peavy, though that is subject to change, certainly, as time goes on. Chris Paulin, the projected starter for tonight's game, 6-7-1, a 3.63 goals against average, .888 save percentage. We may see Jacob Caffrey, but more than likely, let's call it an 85% chance that Chris Paulin is between the pipes tonight for the Carolina Thunderbirds. Another quick break, and when we come back, injuries and transactions, some of the roster changes. There aren't many, but we'll talk you through them on the other side of this break on the Thunderbirds Hockey Network.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill. Relax by our pool and cabana. Gear up at the Pro Shop and sharpen your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green. And play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. Find out more at MapleChaseCC.com.
So it's time for a new car, but where do you go? You could go here, or you could go here. Seriously? Nobody does that anymore. We thought there has to be a better way to buy a car. Where you do it, when you want, where you want, and how you want. So we made one. It's called Go Modern. We made it easy to choose a car you want. Pick your payment, apply for credit, even schedule home delivery. Or just do some of that and finish the rest at one of our 17 dealerships, the way you always have. Go Modern, the new way to experience the modern difference.
The Carolina Thunderbirds have a set of two custom wine labels that can be yours to take home today. The Thunderbirds Red and Carolina White are special edition, first-run custom wine labels for Carolina Thunderbirds fans. Bottles are $40 individually and $75 when bought as a set. Call the Thunderbirds office to get yours today. 336-774-4625.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem on Thunderbirds pregame show. We get set ahead of this one. Carolina and the Delaware Thunder. Injuries and transactions. Couple of names in and out of the lineup tonight for Carolina. Ross Bartlett and Matt Cassino, the two newest Thunderbirds, not in the game tonight. Bartlett out with a lower body injury. Still waiting to hear back on the official word on Matt Cassino. That means Vinny DeAndre back in the lineup tonight for the Thunderbirds. Vaughn Clouston looks to return from his one-game suspension that was handed down to him on Friday night after he vented his frustrations pretty much there at the end of that third period. Alex Basey, again, suspended one game by the FPHL for his participation in that little dust-up with John Batita. And Dustin White has been signed ahead of tonight's contest by the Delaware Thunder. He'll be wearing number 86 in gray tonight. Looks to make an immediate impact with them. And Delaware, again, just about set to take the ice here. So one more quick break, it seems, and we'll be back in a moment here with the keys to tonight's game on the Thunderbirds Hockey Network.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic. The Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, because these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or visit us at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Want to get in on the action? Bring your friends. With group packages of 12 seats or more, tickets start at just $12 a person. Group packages are perfect for church groups, youth groups, business outings, and more. Come together to see your Thunderbirds. Call 336-748-3949 today.
Sarah used 46%,
Josh used 22%, then visited the dealership. Peter used it from beginning to end. Now there's a new way to experience the modern difference. It's called Go Modern, and it's car buying driven by you. Do as much or as little as you want, then visit the dealership and pick up right where you left off. No matter how much you use, Go Modern makes car buying 100% easy. Go Modern, the new way to experience the modern difference.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So we brought the team right onto your home screen.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem. Time for our keys to tonight's game as the Thunderbirds and Thunder get set to take the ice here from the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds. Xanax, first key to tonight's game is a hot start. We talked about it last night. The Thunderbirds surrendered the first goal for the second consecutive night last night, and it wasn't a crushing blow to them. Again, a 4-1 win for the Thunderbirds by the time it was all said and done. But for Carolina, they don't like to start, or they shouldn't like to start from behind and make life any more difficult for themselves than they need it to be. Special teams will be the second key to tonight's game. Thunderbirds' third-ranked power play in the FPHL to this point this season. Had a number of power play goals last night. Dawson Baker and Gus Ford chipped in with the man advantage. They'll look to keep that going again tonight on the power play. And Chris Paulin in goal. He will be the third key to tonight's game. Paulin has to be at his absolute best because we've seen the Delaware Thunder able to take advantage of goaltending struggles as they did on Friday night. So Chris Paulin, second consecutive start. Thunderbirds will turn to him for a solid foundation in goal. One more break, and when we come back, puck drop here on the First Bank first period. Carolina and the Delaware Thunder coming your way after this commercial break.
Family owned and operated.
Sometimes we all need a bit of help. That's where North Carolina Golf Academy comes in.
Let me give you a little tip.
With four instructors ready to get your game to the next level, we're open to the public. Practice on our fully lit driving range and gear up at our pro shop. We're a proudly licensed Callaway dealer.
Give us a call at 336-324-2374.
And visit us in High Point.
There you go. That's a bomb.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
So, it's time for a new truck. But you have this list of places to be and stuff to do. Between getting the groceries, going to work, and picking up the kids, finding time to buy a car seems so overwhelming. That's where Go Modern comes in. With Go Modern, buying a new vehicle is more flexible than ever. No guesswork, just buying and financing made easy. Visit the dealership to make sure you love it, or we'll deliver right to your door. With Go Modern, you're in control. Go Modern, the new way to experience the modern difference.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic. The Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, because these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or visit us at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Want to get in on the action? Bring your friends. With group packages of 12 seats or more, tickets start at just $12 a person. Group packages are perfect for church groups,
Thank you.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem. Carolina and the Delaware Thunder just about set to go here. Thunderbirds start with Chris Paulin in goal as we go with our Pine Hall Brick starting goaltenders of the game. 6-7-1, a 3.63 goals against average, 888 save percentage for the Lockport, New York native. And Trevor Babin is between the pipes here for Delaware. 2-9-0 on the year, 6.15 goals against, 882 save percentage again. 48 saves on 53 shots. Friday night in an overtime win, 6-5 final score for the Delaware Thunder that night. And the Thunderbirds look to go with the Dawson Baker line to start things off, flanked by Jacob Schnapp and Everett Thompson. Vaughn Clouston and Cameron Dimmitt start on the back end here for Carolina. Again, Dimmitt has been enlisted to play defense here over the last stretch of hockey games. Not his typical position there. And for the Thunder, the Laporte line seems to start up front with Ryan Marker. And more as we have one last conversation with the official again. Dustin White, the late signing here for the Thunder, 86 in gray. As Carolina hosting Delaware for the second time wearing their blackout uniforms, again recently released. Those of you who have found the blackout uniforms and enjoyed them, there is the jersey sale page on the Thunderbirds website. As we've got, of course, one last conversation here between the officials and head coach of the Thunder, Lou Santini. Just about ready to go here. Thunderbirds move right to left. Puck is down. We are underway from Winston-Salem. Thanks so much for being with us, everybody. Payne working this one out of the Thunder zone. On it, runs into Dawson. Baker has some trouble. They move this one out to the far side. The outlet pass back through center, taken by Vaughn Clouston, back from his one-game suspension. Schnapp hits the line now, throws that one off a leg. Deflected away, and the rebound taken out of the right-wing corner. Moritz against Dawson Baker, scored a power play goal last night, snapped a four-game goalless drought. It's the young Baker out of Cobourg, Ontario. 30 seconds gone, first bank, first period. Here comes Ryan Marker into the offensive zone, a long shot snap wide there. Rebound collected here by Dawson Baker, Thunderbirds in. Throws it across, Cameron Dimmitt off the boards. Too far for the stick of Everett Thompson. He's on now, John Batita, Thunderbird captain, in the lineup tonight. Now it's Marker at center, off the tape of Batita. Gus Ford able to spin off of Michael Swiderski there. Rebound comes back. Cameron Dimmitt tries to fire one up the right side. Little give and go. Tommy Cardinal finds John Batita inside the line. Tries to fight off a couple of checks. Gus Ford collects. Out of the left wing face-off circle. Thunder have it. It's settled down here by Lucchese. He'll motor on back through center. 18:45 to go first period. Scoreless as here comes Lucchese down the wing. A shot kicked out by Paulin. Rebound rejected back out the center by Ramil Talapov. Moritz moves it out of his own end. It's deflected in. Yuri Pestuka all over that. Another game time decision for Pestuka. He's in the lineup tonight. Made a world of difference last night for Carolina. Got to think that Pestuka would have made a world of difference on Friday night as well. Thunderbirds went down to five defensemen for that game in the absence of Pestuka. Prostyov, Czech Republic native, on the ice right now. The puck is flipped in behind Paulin's goal, and he and Talapov go back to work for it here around the near side boards. Blake Peavy throws a hit there against Swiderski. Nobody really knows where the puck is. Talapov tries to work it free. Daniel Martin and Payne. Now it's back down low, working out of the corner. A thrown in front puck. Pestuka lays out to block the pass and almost deflected up and into the back of the net. 17:51 to go. Peavy back with Martin. Winds and blasts one. Punched out by Babb and the rebound in the slot. Out to the right wing corner now, taken by Dustin White. First big opportunity of the night for the Thunderbirds. Daniel Martin just able to crack one on goal there. Zach Sargis got tangled up there with Steven Fliego in the neutral zone. Both players back on their skates, and the Thunder try to break this puck back out. McNally, a quick pass off to the far side. Dustin White on his back end. He takes a hefty hit from George Holt. This puck poked back in. Here comes Daniel Martin now, near wing. Almost 3 minutes gone here in this first period. No score. One shot apiece. And Zach Sargis advances this one on for Daniel Martin. Throws that one in off of a Thunder defenseman, Quentin Roseboom. Split time here between the Delaware Thunder and Port Huron Prowlers in this 21-22 campaign. He made his presence known against the Thunderbirds with both clubs. Inside 17 to go here. McNally into the offensive zone for Delaware. Takes a number of hits and the loose puck rolls on now for Everett Thompson. Hits the blue line. Pumps on the brakes, and he'll wait for Cameron Dimmitt to come into the zone. Moving it back down low instead now for Dawson Baker. Up high, backhanded pass. Clouston, Dimmitt now fires at right wing corner for Everett Thompson. He collects in behind the Delaware goal. Puck pops up off of a handful of sticks. And now off the glass in behind the goal. Pops out in front for Thompson. A shot. That one denied at the last minute. May have been a Delaware stick in there. A couple of strange bounces there almost result in a big chance for Carolina. Juan Clouston stepped up on one in a big hit. Ryan Marker sidesteps him and fires a puck over the shoulder of Chris Paul and off the glass. And the Thunder and Thunderbirds will battle for this one and kick it back out to center. Baker heads to the bench. Down the right side, that shot thrown on goal by Everett Thompson. Easily sticked away by Babin. Loose puck in front. Here comes Petita. He tries to find Ford. That play shut down, and Ryan Marker's got to be careful here as he takes it out of his own end. 15:51 to go here. First period, no score. Ryan Marker now into the offensive zone with some speed, driving wide. Marker to the goal. A wrap chance there. Paul in the save. He'll hang on. No rebound. And Ryan Marker almost looking like a carbon copy of the play that netted him a goal last night. This time he elects to try and stuff it on the near side post. Paulin was ready. Makes the save and gets a faceoff. 15:42 to go here in this first period. Gus Ford out of a defensive zone faceoff. Unable to win that one. It comes back around. Lucchese on it here. Now out of the right wing corner. Two Thunderbirds and two Thunder. Able to work this one back out in front. Yuri Peshtuka now. Throws that one. Near side, Batita tries to deflect it back for Gus Ford. Nothing doing there. Shut down by Delaware. Quentin Roseboom moves this up the near side. Talipov intercepts and shifts it back down for Ford. McNally now has to work deep out of his own end. Throws that one on for a fellow defenseman, and it's kicked back up past the skates of Swiderski. Gus Ford on that one. On and off the tape of John Batita. And it's waved at here by Ramil Talipov, trying to work that puck free still. And they do out of the left wing corner now. It's Gus Ford, picks it up one-handed. Tries to roll in behind the goal, Gus Ford. Now out of the right side corner, Cardinal throws a hit against Lucchese up top. Long shot, Peshtuka. That one was deflected by Tommy Cardinal. And out of the near side, Batita throws it across. Peshtuka back for Batita. Center point, 14:43 to go. First period brought to you by First Bank. Still looking for the first goal in this one. Batita throws it up now for Talipov. That one, shot pass sent well wide. Ends up in the right wing corner. As Delaware collects this one, head up. Roseboom now down the right side. Hits the red line, throws this one back in behind Paulin's goal. Peshtuka is there against Dustin White. Those two will battle for possession. Heavy check there as Blake Peavy gets involved here. He and McNally come together. The puck rolls free near side now for Ramil Talipov. Novokuznets, Russia native there. Able to move this one back up ahead for Jackson Tucker, who is back in the lineup tonight after being unavailable last night with an upper body injury. A long shot snapped in on Paul, and he makes the save. Tucker poking at the rebound here. Able to work it free. And skating this one back out will be Dimmitt. Down the right side, on and off the tape of Tucker. Fired back in here by Delaware, and icing will be called. 13:47 to go here in this first period. Scoreless from Winston-Salem. We'll be back in 30 seconds after a brief media timeout. Welcome back to Winston-Salem. Scoreless here, 13:47 to go in this First Bank first period. Carolina and Delaware going back to work here. It'll be an offensive zone draw for the Thunderbirds. And a scoreless first, and it was, as this puck is chopped up off the glass there, it'll be settled back down by Everett Thompson. On his backhand, chipping this back around. Babin out of his goal to play it. Right-handed shot, throws that one off the glass. It pops off for White. Turned over, though. Here's a chance for Everett Thompson down the left wing. Out of the corner, in behind the goal, he swings. Looking up top now for George Holt. Finds it off the boards. One-time drive there. That one fought off by Babin. George Holt, eyes as large as dinner plates there. He knew right away he was going to one-time that puck, and boy, did he get a lot of steam on that one. George Holt near side now. Jacob Schnapp Over the blue line. Gets stepped into there by McNally. Still on the puck, trying to move it through. And now here comes Dimmitt with Schnapp in the slot. Tries to find him. The puck was too far behind Schnapp. And it's taken back out here by the Thunder. McNally dishes this one off for Laporte here. Out muscles Talipov. Pass in behind the goal. Laporte just able to move it on far side. Cardinal throws a hit there against Arsenal. Puck settled down back at center by Ryan Marker. Hesitation able to chip this puck back in here. Roseboom finds it over to his defensive partner. 12:39 to go in this first period. Still looking for the first goal in the game. As Cameron Dimmitt almost has his pocket picked there by Marker. Around now it's Talipov. Thunderbird's end. Throws it up now John Batita. Down the left side with Ford cruising towards the goal. Fires that one through the goal mouth in the high slot area. Doesn't find a Thunderbird sweater, and so back out comes Delaware. This one almost chipped in. Could have been a near breakaway there for Marker. Off his tape after some solid defensive work by Von Clouston. Clouston fires that one into the skates of Tommy Cardinal. Collected here by Gus Ford. 3-on-2 back for Carolina. Down the right side. Finds Batita. High slot. Waits in a shot. Stopped by Babin. He hangs on for the rebound again. Second good chance so far in this period for Carolina. Three shots apiece. 12:01 to go in this first period. Thunderbirds trying to break through early here has Babin. You saw him shake that puck out of his goaltending equipment. Got wrapped up in the jersey a little bit. Down the left wing corner, this one. Delaware zone, one back and moved up that far side. Brandon Tutusis turns it over. Peavy now finds Martin chugging over the blue line. It's on and off of his tape and all the way around Swiderski plays it for Moritz. He takes a hit from Jackson Tucker. The puck leaks back up top. Pestuka fires it parallel to the blue line. Nobody home there. Now it's going to be a chance back the other way. Lucchese against Paul and a shot. Stopped by Paul and rebound. He covers it up. Big saves there by Chris Paul and comes out to challenge Lucchese. Stops the man on the rebound. It was a gamble and it paid off for Chris Paulin. 11:34 to go in this first period. 4-3. The Thunder have that slight advantage. Offensive zone draw. One back here by Delaware, but the Thunderbirds quickly take control. Holt leaves it for Von Clouston. A couple of Rochester Hills, Michigan natives working a defensive pairing together. Now it's near side, collected by Dawson Baker, and you can hear the frustration after that pass wouldn't quite land for Dawson Baker. One of the interesting facets of playing in a building with not as many people. There's a turnover in front. Schnapp the shot, saved by Babin. Oh, Baker almost set him up perfectly. As this puck comes back out to center again, Lucchese, long shot off of Clouston. Rebound taken away and collected here by Baker again. Near side, Schnapp, Thunder in the middle of a line change. Thunderbirds carry it on. Schnapp off the boards, Everett Thompson. As we approach 10.5 to go, Schnapp has been taken into the Thunder goal. He quickly gets back up to his skates. Puck underneath, Baker cycles it back up top, Von Clouston. Over the blue line, Holt, right wing corner. Thunderbirds will just chip this one back in and then go for a line change. As near side, it's taken here by Fliego. And motored back out by Tim Payne. Fliego down the right side, trying to break into the Thunderbird zone. Shut down there by Clouston, and it goes past Petita onto the tape of the goaltender Babin. Here's a turnover, though. Gus Ford down the left side, tries to fake his way towards the goal, in behind the net, throws it in front. A sliding Tim Payne blocked that puck, and now Ford still has it in behind the goal. Away from Payne, Gus Ford still with the puck on his backhand now. Up top, Talipov, long shot, save by Babin. No rebound. 10:04 left in this first bank first period. Gus Ford and company knocking on the door. Babin holding it shut. Solid skating by Gus Ford. Trying to work as much time and space as he can. That's where Gus Ford excels. That's what's allowed him to find the back of the net 18 times this season. As off the draw, a shot there. That fell Batita. And now Cardinal tries to get the rebound back off of his captain. Instead, it's Marker back the other way for Delaware. Near side, Asselin. Intercepted by Yuri Pestuka. He was standing in the way. And he dishes back on now for Talipov. Off the backboards, Pestuka inside 10 to go. First period of a scoreless game. Roseboom activates and almost keeps that puck in and throws it into an offensive area for the Thunder. Instead, the Thunderbirds jump in and intercept and back out to center. It'll have to be taken here by Arsenal. Marker down the right side into the offensive end for Delaware. Long shot, easy punch save there by Chris Paulin. Rebound collected here by Tommy Cardinal. Down the right side in front of the Thunder bench. Loses his balance there. May have Clips skates with one of the officials. 9:16 to go, and now here comes Timothy Payne. Tries to work his way around Talipov. Can't do it. Head up. Talipov looks for a pass. He finds Martin, but it slips underneath his stick. Here comes Laporte back the other way. Able to chip it around Dimmitt. Wrestles the puck away from Peavy. Delayed penalty thrown in front. Thunderbirds touch it up. As we will see what the call is here. 9:01 to go in the first period. We'll get that penalty figured out for you. We'll be back in 30 seconds on the Thunderbirds Hockey Network.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health, Wake Forest.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem. Blake Peavy in the box. Two for holding. Thunderbirds find themselves shorthanded for the first time in tonight's contest. Killed off a handful of penalties last night. 2-for-6 on the power play with the Thunderbirds in the game. 76.1% on the penalty kill. Last in the FPHL, so the Thunderbirds here up against it early on. Marker controls in the right wing circle off the faceoff. Working down low, throws it up high, the shot, and that one ends up in the glass. May have clipped Paulin on its way through. Batita throws this one back out down the length of the ice. Trevor Babin out of his goal to play this one away from Daniel Martin. Now it's taken here by Timothy Payne in behind the Delaware goal. Payne strides out with Peavy in the box. Down the right side, Delaware pulls up inside the zone, and Peavy again, one of just two players for the Thunderbirds to suit up in every game this season. Now here's a chance back the other way. It's the other one. John Batita, shorthanded breakaway. He scores! John Batita low to the blocker's side on Babin. Thunderbirds strike first. It's a shorty. John Batita, goal number 16 on the season with Peavy in the box, and the Thunderbirds work things out shorthanded. Batita perhaps a little higher in the zone than his defensive cover typically allows for, but works out for the Thunderbirds captain there as back the other way come the Thunder. Laporte takes a hit from George Holt. The puck comes back out as we've got another delayed penalty here. Babin slowly heads to the box, or the bench rather. George Holt looks to take a tripping penalty against Laporte. Seems the officials looked as though perhaps some knee contact there. Yep. Oh, so it is a kneeing penalty and not a tripping penalty. My apologies there. George Holt in the box, two for kneeing. He joins Blake Peavy. So 5-on-3 coming up here for Delaware. And even though the Thunderbirds just scored that most recent goal shorthanded, they're out to a 1-0 lead. Kind of up against it even more here than they were about 25 seconds ago. Marker controls at the point. A minute of 5-on-3 time here as we've got a whistle and a face-off coming up. There was Laporte in front going at it with Chris Paulin. So they'll move the face-off back out outside of the Thunderbird zone. Baker snaps it back to Gus Ford. Thunderbirds control shorthanded. Down by two men, up by one on the scoreboard. Babin out to drop it off for Ryan Marker. Team leader in goals, assists, and points. Marker moves this one back out across center red into the offensive end. Marker throws this one back on and across. Near side, Marker has it again. Over to the far wing. Chance here for Lucchese. Throws it back near wing. Marker up top. Marker give and go. Right wing circle. Snaps a shot high over the bar. 25 to go on the 5-on-3. Lucchese controls at the left point. Throws it back down low for Swiderski. Waits and throws that one that goes high. Clears the zone. Nope. Marker holds it there. Right point. Fires it across marker. Gets it back. High slot. Lets it go. A nice shot blocked there by Dawson Baker. Rebound collected by Swiderski. Out of the right corner. Marker up top. Fires a backdoor feed. The one-time chance is fanned on. To the rebound is Tommy Cardinal. Clears at the length of the ice. Thunderbirds kill off one penalty. They get Blake Peavy back. 47 seconds remain on the George Holt kneeing minor. Now this one back out. Arsenault is going to have a chance down the right side. Swiderski drops it back. Laporte giving away. John Batita, a shorthanded chance. Back the other way. In against Babbitt. He scores! John Batita, back-to-back shorties. 2-0 Thunderbirds. Do you think he felt a little left out last night? After being ejected, John Batita's got a lot of pent-up offense. He's going to get it out of himself here. 32 to go on the short on the penalty to George Holt. A pair of shorties in this hockey game. They both belong to John Batita. Holt's number 16 and 17 on the season. And the Thunderbirds move this one back out. Still 25 seconds left on the Delaware power play. They'll move it back out across center red. Down the right side, stepped into Von Clausten. Tried to chip that one up off the glass. Tommy Cardinal looked like he wanted to get after it. Now in behind, dropped off by Babin, and the Thunder defenseman will pick this one up. Final 5 seconds, George Holt standing up in the penalty box. Down the right side, Asselin pulls up, makes a nice move between the legs, throws it in front. Yuri Peshtuka got in the way of that one. The official got in the way of Blake Peavy. So the puck taken now here by Steven Fliegel. Big hit there. Now here comes Martin back the other way. Time expires. Holt out of the box. Drops for Clausten. In over the line. Clausten trying to dangle his way through three Thunder players. Almost gets a chance at the far goalpost. Babin makes the stop and Holt's on the rebound. Thunderbirds have three defensemen on the ice right now. Long blast there. Shut down in front. Rebound. Dawson Baker was sniffing around the goal for it. Baker curls and drags up top. Martin the one-timer off the goalpost. It was deflected off the stick of Dustin White. Almost ended up in the back of the net. Everett Thompson now, 5.5 to go, first period. Thunderbirds lead it 2-0. Shot by Baker, knocked down. Martin on the rebound, lets it go. A shot off the crossbar, and it stays out. Oh, and after the play, Dawson Baker gets more, and now Everett Thompson wants a piece of somebody. Baker got a stick up high, and now Payne's got a hold of Everett Thompson. They're not going to drop the gloves. Payne and Thompson won't let go of one another. Baker got a stick up high. Damian Poole has hopped the bench, and he's over to give a bit of a look here to Dawson Baker. Make sure he's doing all right. So Thompson and Payne are separated here. Thompson's escorted back to the Thunderbirds bench. Payne to the penalty box. Looks as though Payne's going to get two for high sticking here against Baker. And somebody else came over and gave Baker the extra little shove. Thompson took exception. We may be looking at a number of penalties here. Only one is up on the board right now, and it is Timothy Payne. Thunderbirds go to their first power play. As long as Everett Thompson is not grabbed after the fact and sent back to the Thunderbirds penalty box. And it looks like that won't be the case, so your typical run-of-the-mill 5-on-4 for 2 minutes. Thunderbirds, first power play of the game, third in the FPHL at 21.2%. Now here's a chance, John Batita up high. Baker the shot, saved by Babin. Ryan Marker got in the way there, and Baker settles it down. Ford, near side, keeps it in, drops for Batita. Wants to go across, Baker the shot, he scores! Dawson Baker gets his revenge in the form of a goal on the power play. It's 3-0. Back-to-back nights with a power play goal for Dawson Baker. Fifth of the season, Thunderbirds up 3-0. We talked about the special teams being an important key to tonight's game, and well, so far so good. A pair of shorthanded goals, you don't expect or plan for those, and a power play goal scored by Dawson Baker. 3-0 Carolina. Inside 5 to go, first period, Thunder. Trying to chug back the other way, stop the bleeding. Asselin rolls back in, tries to wrap one around here on Paulin. Martin steals from him, and the Thunderbirds have speed coming back the other way. Dimmitt follows on here after Martin lost the puck. Around to the near side, tries to chip it through. Dimmitt trying to work it free for Vinny DeAndre. He throws this one all the way around the far wing. Blake Peavy drops it up top for Martin. Sliding over to him. A chance there, one of the fallen Thunder players. It looked like Swiderski. Now it's backdoor chance here for Talapov. Tries to throw it in front. Vinny DeAndre was in the slot. Talapov works it back. DeAndre throws a hit. The puck rolls free here. Arsenault throws it up the far side boards. Martin at the point. Wants to take a shot. Nobody challenges him. Finally takes one. It's deflected away by Lucchesi. Talapov on it. Left wing chance. A shot in front. Saved by Babin. With Peavy on the doorstep. 4:05 to go. Goals by Batita. And Dawson Baker have the Thunderbirds out to a 3-0 lead.
Sometimes, we all need a bit of help. Come on. That's where North Carolina Golf Academy comes in.
Let me give you a little tip.
With four instructors ready to get your game to the next level, we're open to the public. Practice on our fully lit driving range and gear up at our pro shop. We're a proudly licensed Callaway dealer.
Give us a call at 336-324-2374.
And visit us in High Point.
There you go. That was a bomb.
Want to get in on the action?
Welcome back to Winston-Salem. Thunderbirds lead it 3-0. Two shorthanded goals by John Batita. Power play goal by Dawson Baker. Thunderbirds are firmly in the driver's seat of this one. And the Batita line stands on again to try and widen the gap even more. 4:01 to go here in the first. This one moved back out and taken by Von Clouston. Away from Tommy Cardinal, and taking a spill there is Justin Laporte. This one comes back out now. Here comes Marker, stepped into by Clouston in front of the Thunderbirds bench. John Batita up into the skates of Yuri Peshtuka. Now thrown back in and around J.C. Moritz. Able to chop this one up the far side boards. Spinning away there, Laporte from Batita. It's a bit of a stick check from the Thunderbird captain, and Laporte throws it near wing for Marker. Staring down Yuri Peshtuka, he hits the line and throws it in behind Paulin's goal. 3:24 to go in this first period, 3-0, thanks to Batita and Baker. Peshtuka shuts down that chance, finds John Batita. Down the left side he comes, a full head of steam. Cardinal chugging towards the goal as well, a chance in front. Two big saves by Babin as he shuts down Cardinal from point-blank range. Rebound up top, Holt a long shot, gloved and saved by Trevor Babin. Tommy Cardinal had unfettered access there to that near side goalpost. Nobody really too quick to get over there as Cardinal started whacking away at that puck. Babin made two saves. Did a good job sealing the goalpost there, so no chance at a goal there for Cardinal, but off the draw, Babin pokes it away. Baker able to throw this one up off the goal line. In the back of the net, Schnapp works it up top. Schmidt in the shot, a save, rebound, and the chance by Baker sent wide as Babin is down in the goal crease. Play continues here. He got some contact there. 2:51 to go. Two shots by Dawson Baker. Babin taking a second to get up here. Take a stoppage here. 2:51 in this period. And this time, the crowd it draws is mostly civil. Babin laid out as looked as though Tommy Cardinal was, or Dawson Baker rather, was cutting through the slot there. Some contact. Now a whistle and we're ready to get back to it now. Right wing faceoff. One back here by the Thunderbirds. Baker in behind the Thunder goal. Trying to work his way around. Looks up top once. Cameron Dimmitt finds him with a pass. Walks the line and shoots one. A stick save by Babin. Clears that puck out to the far wing. Thompson battling for it there. Delaware comes away with it. They work it back out through center. Sidestepping George Holt. The puck laid behind, though. They'll try to chip it forward for Dawson Baker, but can't do it. And so Arsenault takes over instead for Delaware. Give and go near side. Dustin White over the line. Drops it back for Fliego. A shot. That one sent wide. Spurs the Thunderbirds' breakout, or at least it almost did, as Everett Thompson is able to leave this one off for Jacob Schnapp. Babin deflects that one with the paddle of his stick on the cross-corner dump-in. Baker trying to make life difficult for Timothy Payne, and he does so. But Payne still hangs onto the puck here. 2-minute warning, first bank, first period. 3-0 Thunderbirds lead it right now. It's this puck chipped into the cross corner. Cameron Dimmitt back to get it here with George Holt. Throws it around near side. Everett Thompson away from Payne. Puck squirts three. George Holt able to move this one back around now for Dimmitt. Throws it off the boards, intended for Martin, intercepted by Delaware. Shuffled back underneath, and Dimmitt gets taken into the boards again here by Swiderski. One of the Thunder player tumbles down. McNally chips it back for Moritz at the point. Takes a couple of bounces off the glass and boards, and inside 90 seconds, Holtz able to Aylmer this one up to Daniel Martin, and a high stick. Martin knocked that puck down. That'll send this faceoff way back down the other way. Right idea for the Thunderbirds, as again, they're letting their offensive creativity flow here. It is all guns blazing right now for the Carolina Thunderbirds. Taking chances shorthanded, taking a chance with the aerial pass. It's kind of been phased in and out of the game. It was real popular around 2016, 2017. More teams, the long shot there is blocked off the draw. More teams electing to go to that airmail pass. Tough to execute, but when it works, you're almost guaranteed an odd man rush back the other way. Kind of been phased out, but the Thunderbirds reviving it a bit here. And Pastuca, a point shot, deflected on its way and chopped back out. McNally, a nice try to get that puck away from Jackson Tucker. Martin tries to steal it, high slot. Chance back the other way here for the Thunder. Ryan Marker away from Jackson Tucker. Final 60 seconds left of the frame. 54.5 to go, offside is called. The faceoff comes just outside the Thunderbird zone. One last chance here for Delaware. Try to get something going here at the end of the period. Peavy and Marker to go forward here. Roller hockey teammates over the summer. Teammates up in Elmira in the shortened season. 2021, the spring season. And as Martin plays this one off the boards in front of his own bench, throws it up now. Jackson Tucker down the right wing. Stomps on the brakes with 37 to go. Moving this one back on now for his center in Blake Peavy. Martin tries to give him some help. Can't do it there. Laporte wrestled by Peavy, but Laporte comes away with the puck. 3-on-3 as they hit the line. Stepped into Jiří Pešťuka. He'll take away the puck and move it on now for Martin. He and Petita, a bit of miscommunication. Peavy helps it on, though. And now here comes Petita with Peavy. Down the left side, Petita wants to throw it in front instead. Button hooks in behind the goal, throws one in front. Cardinal the shot, big save, Babbitt. Rebound, Cardinal. Oh, and another save by Babbitt. Wrap chance by Cardinal, stays out. He's still got the puck. 5 to go. One more shot. Talipov through traffic. He scores! Tommy Cardinal. A deflection in front. He and Blake Peavy were there. 2 to go in the period. It's 4-0 Carolina. After a huge net mouth scramble, tons of chances for Cardinal and Peavy in front. The shot by Talipov was deflected. It was Blake Peavy. Goals in back-to-back games for Peavy. Number 5 on the season. The first even strength goal of this hockey game, if you can believe that, as we'll have to redrop the puck here. And time expires. Just a quick little drop there. Dawson Baker's got some more for Timothy Payne right now. Those two got tangled up off the faceoff. And they will finally clear the benches and head back off. We're not going to send you to a commercial break quite yet because Baker and Payne and Lucchese still have more for one another. So finally those will be separated. I believe we can call this one right here. First period ends 4-0. No more battles on the ice, at least for right now. We'll take a quick break. First intermission coming your way. A pair of shorties by John Petita. A power play goal by Dawson Baker. And Blake Peavy, most recent goal, 4-0 Thunderbirds from Winston-Salem after 20 minutes. We'll be back here with the first intermission on the Thunderbirds Hockey Network.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So, we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill. Relax by our pool and cabana. Gear up at the Pro Shop and sharpen your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green. And play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. Find out more at MapleChaseCC.com.
So it's time for a new car, but where do you go? You could go here, or you could go here. Seriously? Nobody does that anymore. We thought there has to be a better way to buy a car. Where you do it, when you want, where you want, and how you want. So we made one. It's called Go Modern. We made it easy to choose a car you want. Pick your payment, apply for credit, even schedule home delivery. Or just do some of that and finish the rest at one of our 17 dealerships, the way you always have. Go Modern, the new way to experience the modern difference.
The Carolina Thunderbirds have a set of two custom wine labels that can be yours to take home today. The Thunderbirds Red and Carolina White are special edition, first-run custom wine labels for Carolina Thunderbirds fans. Bottles are $40 individually and $75 when bought as a set. Call the Thunderbirds office to get yours today, 336-774-4625.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic. The Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, because these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or visit us at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Want to get in on the action? Bring your friends with group packages of...
Welcome back to Winston-Salem for our first intermission report here. After 20 minutes of play, 4-0, the Carolina Thunderbirds on top of the Delaware Thunder. 17-5, the shots in that first period. It has been a lopsided affair for Carolina so far. Role reversal from Friday night in Delaware. The Thunderbirds have found their stride, and it came in an unexpected fashion. Shorthanded goals, two of them by John Batita, both scored on the breakaway. Kind of changed up his moves a little bit there, but the end result was the same. Carolina has been off and running since then. Special teams would continue. Dawson Baker cranking home a power play goal, his second power play goal in as many games. And then right there at the end of the frame, after a scramble in front by Tommy Cardinal, had a couple of chances there. Trevor Babin made two saves on him. The Thunderbirds worked the puck back out up top. Talipov's long shot deflected home by Blake Peavy. With 2 seconds left in the period, the Thunderbirds made it a 4-0 game. And right now, again, the conversation right now in the locker room is just keep doing what you're doing. The status quo has been the way to go here for the Thunderbirds in this first period. They've been taking a lot of chances here. Again, the shorthanded breakaways. Batita flying high in the zone, trying to look for an escape pass, and he found it twice. It paid off. There won't be many games in which the Thunderbirds can play like this, but this certainly seems to be one of them here. Everything just opening up offensively for them. Give Trevor Babin a lot of credit, though. 13 saves so far in this period. He's been busy. He's been knocked around a bit. Took some contact about midway through that first period, but no worse for wear there. John Batita, 4 points right now for the Thunderbirds. Scored 2 goals and assisted on the other two. Gus Ford's got an assist. Ramil Talipov as well. And the Thunderbirds' top line continuing to do what it does best. Batita and company leading the way here for Carolina on this Sunday game. But still, even though it's a 4-0 game, the Thunderbirds can't find themselves being complacent, needing to come back out, keeping their collective foot on the gas, as the saying goes. And it's one of those games, you saw a perfect example of it on Friday night. Delaware took the foot off the gas. Thunderbirds came out in the third period, scored 4 unanswered to tie the game, and well, a fifth one to take the lead for a moment. But it is possible. It's not out of the question. And especially at this level, the way the game is played here, it's a 4-goal deficit. Certainly not a death sentence at this stage, but for the Thunderbirds, He's trying to keep going the way they've been going. Chris Paulin hasn't been tested often, but he's looked pretty solid. Five saves in that first period. 4 points for Batita, four goals on the board for the Carolina Thunderbirds. We'll send you another break, and when we come back, take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard. This is not the only game in the FPHL tonight. All that and more coming up next, and we do remind you listening and watching at home, kind of goes without saying, but if you can avoid it, don't drive. The roads are getting progressively worse out there, so if you can stay home, go ahead and stay home. That's why we've got the Thunderbirds on the TV and the radio for you. 4-0 the score after the first period. First intermission coming your way after this.
Family owned and operated since 1938, Mustin and Crutchfield Food Market in Kernersville is the place to find your favorite homemade foods. Sample the finest cuts of meat from our on-site butcher, enjoy a glass bottle of soda like the old days, and go home with a tub of our famous homemade pimento cheese. Come see us at 245 North Main Street in downtown Kernersville.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill. Relax by our pool and cabana. Gear up at the Pro Shop and sharpen your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green. And play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. Find out more at MapleChaseCC.com. Conveniently located at the corner of Rinalda Road and Northwest Boulevard, Salem Smiles and Dr. Sarah C. Schoaf is the preferred orthodontist of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Dr. Schoaf is a Winston-Salem native and a trusted name in orthodontics since 1992. So whether you're on the ice or in the stands, trust your teeth to Dr. Smashmouth and her team at Salem Smiles. The Carolina Thunderbirds have a set of two custom wine labels that can be yours to take home today. The Thunderbirds Red and Carolina White are special edition, first-run custom wine labels for Carolina Thunderbirds fans. Bottles are $40 individually and $75 when bought as a set. Call the Thunderbirds office to get yours today, 336-774-4625.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So, we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another...
Welcome back to Winston-Salem and the first intermission report here. Carolina leading the Delaware Thunder by a score of 4-0. 4 points for John Batita to this point. 2-2 for the Carolina captain. Pumping his point totals up on the season a considerable amount. And not the only game in the FPHL tonight, though. And still some more goals being scored all over the place. Columbus and Port Huron will still waiting for those two to drop the puck. That'll be a 6:05 start time there, so we won't get any news on them until about the third period of tonight's game here from Winston. But 4-1 right now. Watertown is visiting Binghamton, and Watertown is having their way with the Black Bears right now. Tifu, a pair of goals by day, and you guessed it, Justin McDonald. Ever heard of him? The 4 goals scored by the Watertown Wolves. McDonald continues to terrorize goaltenders all across the FPHL, leading his team in goals, leading the league in scoring for what seems like the entire season. McDonald, 52 points so far this year, one more than Nikita Ivashkin. Alexander Jemayev in third in league scoring with 45 points. McDonald's 24, good enough for second in the league. Ivashkin, the only one with more than he does, with 31. So those two going head-to-head tonight. Ivashkin been held off the score sheet so far. Corey Sherman assisted by Jurich and Newberg, the only Binghamton goal on the board right now. And the Black Bears, this is a pivotal game for them as well. The Thunderbirds, again, picking up a win last night, trying to click back up into fourth place. Binghamton and Carolina have kind of been going back and forth for fourth place in that final playoff position all year. Once in a while, Port Huron will slip up in there. The Prowlers currently in sixth right now, but it seems as though as the race tightens up, there will be less and less movement. There's still going to be movement from now until the time the playoffs are set in mid-April, but it becomes harder and harder to do as the season goes on. Watertown continues to break away. Delaware still back down here at the bottom of the league. So for the middle of the pack teams, Carolina and Binghamton, these games incredibly important. So for the Thunderbirds, they look to continue their scoring ways and keep the puck out of the back of the net. Goes without saying, though. And after this break, we're going to tell you how the Thunderbirds look to do that coming up in this second period after these messages from our sponsors.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill. Relax by our pool and cabana. Gear up at the Pro Shop and sharpen your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green. And play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. Find out more at MapleChaseCC.com.
So it's time for a new car, but where do you go? You could go here, or you could go here. Seriously? Nobody does that anymore. We thought there has to be a better way to buy a car. Where you do it, when you want, where you want, and how you want. So we made one. It's called Go Modern. We made it easy to choose the car you want. Pick your payment, apply for credit, even schedule home delivery. Or just do some of that and finish the rest at one of our 17 dealerships, the way you always have. Go Modern, the new way to experience the modern difference.
The Carolina Thunderbirds have a set of two custom wine labels that can be yours to take home today. The Thunderbirds Red and Carolina White are special edition, first-run custom wine labels for Carolina Thunderbirds fans. Bottles are $40 individually and $75 when bought as a set. Call the Thunderbirds office to get yours today. 336-774-4625.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic. The Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, because these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or visit us at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem for the final time on the first intermission report. Thunderbirds lead it 4-0 here. The scoring, John Batita, 4 points so far in this first period, and they look to return to that line. The keys in this second period, the idea is play the way you've been playing, but don't give up too much defensively. It's very easy in a game like this to completely forget about defense altogether, and that puts you in some sticky situations, and the Thunderbirds cannot afford to blow a 4-goal lead on home ice, regardless of the circumstance, regardless of the opponent. They just can't afford to do it at this point in the season with so many points on the line and so much ground to cover if they want to make sure that they have a dance partner in the playoffs once they roll around in April. So not forgetting about the defensive game will be the key for the Thunderbirds here in this second period. They look to stay out of the penalty box, as they've done so pretty well, though even when they didn't, it didn't exactly matter. Two shorthanded goals in that second period, but the Thunderbirds kind of look to maintain the status quo here as they come out for the second period. Garrett Rutledge and his team heading back onto the ice right now. One last break, and when we come back, puck drop here on the Modern Automotive second period when we come back on the Thunderbirds Hockey Network.
Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist helps you do more of the things you love. More laughs, more adventures, more hugs. We combine the brightest minds in medicine to bring you world-class care with a commitment to strengthen the health and wellness of our community. Because when it comes to the health of you and your family, no one should settle for anything short of life-changing.
Conveniently located at the corner of Rinalda Road and Northwest Boulevard, Salem Smiles and Dr. Sarah C. Schoaf is the preferred orthodontist of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Dr. Schoaf is a Winston-Salem native and a trusted name in orthodontics since 1992. So whether you're on the ice or in the stands, trust your teeth to Dr. Smashmouth and her team at Salem Smiles.
Want to get in on the action? Bring your friends. With group packages of 12 seats or more, tickets start at just $12 a person. Group packages are perfect for church groups, youth groups, business outings, and more. Come together to see your Thunderbirds. Call 336-748-3949 today.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So, we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
Family owned and operated since 1938, Mustin and Crutchfield Food Market in Kernersville is the place to find your favorite homemade foods. Sample the finest cuts of meat from our on-site butcher, enjoy a glass bottle of soda like the old days, and go home with a tub of our famous homemade pimento cheese. Come see us at 245 North Main Street and
welcome back to Winston-Salem as we are just about set to get going here on the Modern Automotive second period. Thunderbirds moving left to right here. Chris Paulin back in the Carolina goal crease. He and Trevor Babin continue the man-on-man battle. 17-5, Thunderbirds outshot Delaware in that first period. Dawson Baker's line starts out. Schnapp on his left, Thompson on his right. Gibbett and Clausen on the back end, and Delaware wins the opening faceoff of the second period. Back, and it's J.C. Moritz trying to find Laporte back the other way. Marker slamming his stick on the ice. He wants that puck. Puck rolls up on Laporte. Oh, and a quick whistle there. As Paulin looked to have that puck covered, it bounces off the paddle of his goal stick and squeaks free. Delaware not thrilled about that one. Whistle and a faceoff coming in the defensive zone here for Carolina. Off the draw, Cameron Dimmitt controls here in front of his own net. Throws this one across near side. Clouston up off the boards, off of Everett Thompson, and Jacob Schnapp and Dawson Baker can't break up the Delaware breakout. Now Moritz throws this one near side. Laporte able to just chip this one in. Dimmitt looks off and carries this one back around the horn. It comes, a long shot there, easily sticked aside by Chris Paulin. That one coming off the stick of Michael Swiderski. As this one thrown near side, Thompson catches up to that Schnapp pass. Thompson towards the goal, tries to push that one through. No one home in the back door, but Thompson continuing the pressure there, trying to muscle that puck away from Timothy Payne, and he couldn't do it. And behind the Delaware goal, Alexi Arsenault able to send this one back out for Marker near side. Pocket almost picked there by Gus Ford. Thunderbird center, forechecking in deep right now, and Marker forced back in. Thunderbirds doing a great job forechecking and not allowing the Thunder any room for movement so far in this first period. Is this one near side into the skates of Yuri Peshtuka. Out off the near side boards, Arsenault throws it D to D off the boards, taken there by Quentin Roseboom, and in front of the Delaware goal, this one squirts out far side. Gus Ford sticks a shoulder there from McNally. Cardinal follows on and carries this puck around wide out of the right wing corner. Pass the tape of Jackson Tucker. Thunderbirds shuffling the lines a little bit here. Now back the other way comes Delaware. It's Marker again. Hits the line in front of Peshtuka. Long shot. Deflects off of the stick of Yuri Peshtuka. It would seem up and out of play. Whistle and a faceoff looks to come up here in the Thunderbird zone. 18-16 to go here in this second period. Leading on the shot boards, 17-7. As quick faceoff coming up here. Puck is down out of the defensive zone. George Holt able to swing this one on Cameron Dimmitt now. In from behind the Zamboni doors, Holt. Near side, DeAndre. Collected here by George Holt. Back across center end and over the blue line. Holt on this one, a long shot off the window. Kicked out there by Blake Peavy. Holt, the defenseman, working this one back in deep. Out of the right side corner, Thunderbird's offensive end. Daniel Martin throws this one back down, collected by Peavy. Tried to throw it in front for DeAndre. He couldn't handle it. Now it comes back out the other way, and Marker and company can bring this one back ahead here for Delaware. Back through center, poked at by Lucchese. In behind Paulin's net. He's after it and around. Lucchese on there. Tries to find this one. They'll battle for it in front of the Thunder bench. Now it's sent back down here. Timothy Payne in the defensive zone. Gets taken down. Puck rolls free. Here's a chance. DeAndre for Peavy. A shot. He scores! Blake Peavy, second of the night. 5-0 Thunderbirds. Solid forecheck there for Carolina. It pays off. Blake Peavy, right place, right time, makes no mistake. His sixth goal of the season has Carolina up by 5. And as we get set to drop the puck, we'll keep you here on Thunderbirds TV. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification on the Thunderbirds Radio Network. Back into the offensive end, in around for Carolina. Clouston gets a bit of an extra tup here, and they're going to go. Tutusis grabs Clouston, and he's wailing away. Late comes Everett Thompson. Tutusis wailing on Clouston. He's still down in the blue paint. Those two got tiled up. Everyone finds a dance partner. Dawson Baker's trying to get in at somebody. And it seemed as though Clouston and Tutusis just kind of got tangled up in one another. Tutusis didn't like it. He grabs all of Von Clouston and starts wailing away. As Von Clouston is still down on the ice in the goal crease there. Everett Thompson's got more for Tutusis. He's got his shoulder pads all rolled up. Hey, 16:56 to go in this second period, and it seemed as though the tensions between these two clubs had kind of cooled off a little bit. Clouston was breaking back through center, took a stick from Tutusis and went down. Not sure if there was already a delayed penalty, but Tutusis had jumped on Clouston, and Everett Thompson came in to offer his services as well. 16:56 to go. Tutusis is in the penalty box. Clouston is headed back to the Thunderbirds dressing room. Damian Poole follows him back there as well, and this was Friday night was Clausen's return from injury. Tonight was his return from suspension, and the night may be over for the next little while here. As Tutusis grabs his gear, and he seems to be done for the night. Brandon Tutusis skates off at 16:56 to go here in this second period. Tutusis and Clouston didn't seem to be parts of any of the scrums here over this hockey game to this point. But again, you don't know what's said down on the ice because we're not there. We're up here, and all the microphones are up here as well. So perhaps a good thing, and just leaves you scratching your head as to what brought that about. Some frustrations, obviously, for Delaware. And again, we're only able to speculate up here from our spot in the broadcast booth. But frustrations are high. The Thunder have just allowed a fifth goal. Clouston cuts through. Perhaps Tutusis thought Clouston went down easily, trying to sell a call. who knows? And the tensions and the frustration and the anger just kind of all boiled over there. Second time in as many nights that one of the Thunderbirds finds themselves down on the ice being wailed away at with some fists. Although last night a bit more understandable, Batita got the stick into the midsection of Alex Basie. This one leaves you scratching your head a little bit here. Gus Ford and Ryan Marker have come over to sort out the damage. Jacob Schnapp seems to have taken a penalty out of all this as well. He strides over to the Carolina penalty box. Everett Thompson is not in all of this quite yet. Not sure if he was sent back. He's hopping the bench right now, and that's what we were waiting for. Thompson coming in late here. And Everett Thompson may be done for the night. Everett Thompson does seem to be done for the night. Vaughn Clouston hops back on, and we'll keep an eye on him as he skates past the Delaware bench. John Batita trying to keep the legs loose here. 16:56 to go in this second period. Schnapp may be serving Thompson's penalty, so that may be what's going on here. And again, this all comes after a couple of days in a row of tensions boiling. And again, you got to think, if Friday isn't quite as emotional of a hockey game as it is, we might not have the situation we have right now. But what's curious about all this is, if there was still this much tension, why wasn't it seen later last night? After the Basie and Batita exchange, things kind of quieted down. Things almost went silent there. Thunderbirds come out with three goals in the second period. Really no fights, no dust-ups, not even a mean glance thrown back and forth through the duration of the game. And Tutusis and Clouston, not really any sort of history there. Just leaves you scratching your head. 5-0 to score. Thunderbirds firmly out ahead. As we've got another Thunder player skating over, Dustin White. So it seems as though it'll just be the two game misconducts, I guess. That'll be all that goes up on the board right now. 4-on-4 is what the linesman has up right now, or it would seem he's got up right now. Chris Kwong to drop the puck here. Same officiating crew as we've had over the last little bit. John Batita after the draw here, and the penalty is just being announced here right now as play continues, so we'll do our best to report back to you and still call the game. 16:45 to go. Thunderbirds with a 5-0 lead. We're skating at 4-on-4 right now. Lucchese breaks into the zone. That one shut down, and Dimmitt almost has his pocket picked. Diving now, trying to work that puck back out. He gets it as far as center. And John Batita motors on, almost gets tripped up there by Lucchese. Tries to get taken out of the play. Batita high in the zone, finds Cameron Dimmitt down the right side. What a pass there, a shot deflected as Gus Ford was cutting through the goal crease. That puck up and out of play, and here's the announcement. Schnapp picked up two for roughing. Everett Thompson, third man in. He's done for the night. Tutusis picks up a fighting major and a game misconduct. 5-10 there, he's done. This is puck up and out of play, 16:15 to go. So a minor penalty up on the board for Carolina, 1:19 to go on that minor. Major penalty for Tutusis, 4:20 of that is left. So it'll be a shortened major power play for the Thunderbirds once Schnapp is released. So back out through center, Dawson Baker can't force this one back into the Delaware zone, and this one collected back out here by Swiderski at the blue line, almost has his pocket picked by Tommy Cardinal. Gives him a couple of chops, and this one down the right side, Pastuca leaping after to try and knock that puck free. Up top, it's Moritz. Top of the circle's a shot kicked out by Paulin. A little slow to get back up the Thunderbirds net miner and Peavy. Pastuca drops it now for Talipov. Yuri Peshtuka out of his own end. Throws this one on and across now for Emil Talapov. Baker and Cardinal get tangled up. 3-on-3 as the Thunderbirds hit the line. It's Cardinal with Baker breaking towards the goal and the pass too far behind him. 34 seconds at 4-on-4. Von Clouston gets it back from Emil Talapov. Under a stick. Nice heavy hit there at open ice. Tommy Cardinal says hi to Michael Swiderski. Puck rolls free and it's taken here by Talapov. Drops it off. Cardinal down the left side. Button hooks. Wants to go back up top for Clouston and does. 17 to go in the 4-on-4. 15-10 to go here in this Modern Automotive second period. Cardinal switches up the hands on the stick to receive the pass and he gives it back to Gus Ford. High slot, top of the circle, lets it go. Save made, Babin. Rebound too far for Clouston. Jacob Schnapp is out of the box. Short power play here for Carolina. Right side, Ford trying to dangle his way through Moritz. Can't get the shot off. As this one cleared back out off the skates of Clouston, Gus Ford can't touch it on the delayed offsides. So a little less than 3 minutes on this Thunderbirds power play. Thrown down the length of the ice, Von Clouston is here. Off the boards, Lucchese's shot into the midsection of Von Clouston. Knocked down and back out comes Jackson Tucker. Chugging forward, full head of steam. Still 14:25 to go in this second period. Sorting out those penalties took a considerable amount of time as Gus Ford goes down. Just getting back up to his skates now. Batita races after this puck. Lucchese after Batita. Paulin out of his goal to play it. Nicely pirouettes away from Lucchese. Bit of a dangerous moment there for the Thunderbird goaltender, but apt at playing the puck and does so there. Dimon hits the line, drops for Ford. Offensive zone here for Carolina. High shot. Saved by Trevor Babin. 13:59 to go, second period. We'll take a 30-second media timeout. 5-0 Carolina. For all the fights and goals, they've got a pretty considerable lead. We'll be back in 30 seconds. Five nothing, the Thunderbirds still in the power play here as we're still pretty early on in the second period. 2:03 of power play time here, and again, it's a major penalty to Brandon Tutusis. So the Thunderbirds, if they score, penalty remains up there, and they'll keep on skating at 5-on-4 until time on the infraction expires. Laporte waved out of a defensive zone faceoff here. Swiderski comes in to take it against Blake Peavy and taps Arsenal. Faceoff one back to Cameron Dimmitt, knifed away from him, and here comes Swiderski with a full head of steam against Paulin and Clouston in a nice defensive play. Clouston pokes that puck away at the last second. Swiderski trying to swat it away off the tape of Cameron Dimmitt. On the right side comes Dawson Baker with the puck, breaking into the Thunder end and throws it off the boards. Now picked up here by Jackson Tucker. Out of his skates, collected by Blake Peavy. High slot, two goals already tonight. Give and go back with Von Clouston. It leaks back out towards center. Dimmitt collects there, Thunderbirds territory. Clouston kicking this one up, 13:20 to go in a 5-0 hockey game. Two goals by John Bettina. Two goals by Blake Peavy and a Dawson Baker power play goal sandwiched there between the four. Baker, as the Thunderbirds get a line change here, walks in and shoots one. That one deflected wide again. Peavy got a touch on that. He's feeling it tonight. DeAndre up top. Peshtuka walks, gives it near side Baker. DeAndre gets it back, high slot, lets it go. A shot and a save by Babin. Vinny DeAndre gets a shot there. Not typically getting a ton of power play time, but tonight a 5-0 game. Why not throw him out there? He gets a good shot on goal. In an eerily quiet Winston-Salem Fairgrounds, Zanuck. Certainly would not be the case if not for the weather outside, but a brave few have ventured out to the annex to see the Thunderbirds play, and so far they've been treated to a pretty good show. DeAndre deep in the offensive zone, 50 seconds to go on the power play, 12:44 in the second period, 5-0 Thunderbirds, looking to make it 6 here. Zach Sargis on the power play now. Down the left point, he's got Peavy up top, send it through. Peshtuka, far side Sargis, time and space, lets it go, shot up and over the glass. Off the glass, it comes now to Martin. Right wing faceoff circle. Looking up top, Pastuca cocked and ready to go for the one-timer. Martin instead flips it back down low for Peavy. Gets it back. Martin, one-time drive, Pastuca punched out by Babin. 20 seconds to go on the power play. Martin up top, Pastuca slides it across. Sarr just walks in and fires one. That hits the glass and rims around. Pastuca keeps it in, takes a check. Far side, Sargis drifting down low right in front. A deflecting chance there by Peavy. Goes by the wayside. Cardinal holds the line. Power play time expires. Delaware's killed it off. Thunderbirds 1-for-2 on the power play tonight. This one moved back out. They've gotten more goals shorthanded than power play goals tonight. As Zach Sargis backtracks in his own end. 11:32 to go. Second period as we approach the halfway point of this game. All Thunderbirds to this point. Cardinal trying to advance this one back out as Laporte won't make it easy for him. McNally throws this one in its glove down here. Thunderbirds in. Quick little give and go. Clausen had some trouble with it. Petita taps it on now for Ford. Down the right side, Gus Ford, 13-game point streak. Throws this one through for Cardinal. Tries to swing it on goal, and Babin had some trouble with that one. Tommy Cardinal had his scoring streak snapped the other night. Been extremely effective over the last little bit here as Marker tries the wrap chance again on Chris Paul, and the puck rolls off his stick. Cardinal throws it around for Zach Sargis now. Taken into the boards here by Laporte. 10:45 to go in the second. All the way around it comes Gus Ford on the goal line. Von Clouston, and it's turned over. Arsenal throws that one off the leg of Cardinal. That stung a bit. And this one played back in offsides as the Thunder can't touch it. Fortunate break there for Carolina. As Delaware would have had numbers back in all alone in the offensive zone. Instead, it's Tommy Cardinal now. Down the right side against Babin. Long shot, glove save, Babin. Holds for a faceoff. 10:18 to go, second period. Final game of the weekend. Final home game of January for the Carolina Thunderbirds. Just a handful of home dates this month. As they'll be back at home quite a bit more in February. They round out January with a trip to Columbus and then Danbury. As the schedule just keeps clipping along. 27th game of the season for Carolina right now. We're getting pretty darn close to the halfway point. Thrown up top now from the high slot. Kicked out by Babin. The shot by Jackson Tucker. That puck almost intercepted, and now back out comes George Holt. Racing after it, no icing. George Holt pulls up and throws it on now for Dimmitt. Near side, Tucker on and across. George Holt, puck explodes off his stick. He skates on, Holt drop pass. Peavy lets it go, a shot stopped by Babin. The rebound chance, Peavy almost found that puck on the back door. Two goals tonight for Peavy. He is feeling it tonight. Garrett Rutledge throws him back out on the ice, why not? Flago throws this one near side for Asselin. Dimmitt recycles it off the boards now for Peavy. Hits the red line, gets dunked by Lucchese. Now Jacob Schnapp's got the puck. Backdoor feed, DeAndre a shot. He scores! Vinny DeAndre, 6-0 Thunderbirds. Vinny gets one here. You kind of had the feeling DeAndre was going to get one. Been making right decisions all night. Been a soldier for the Thunderbirds this season. Anytime they've needed him, he has been there. Had an assist already in tonight's game, and the goal for DeAndre makes it 6-0 Thunderbirds. Played 16 games for Carolina in the 1920 season. Goal and four assists then. But the goal tonight, his first since December 21st, 2019 in Menor. It was a 2-1 win that night, DeAndre. First goal in quite some time, and it gets Carolina a 6-0 lead. Blown down 9:01, and now 9 minutes to go here in this second period. And it looks as though we'll take a penalty here. Into the box goes DeAndre. Tripping call here. We're a little too engrossed in the stats. Vinny DeAndre, a goal, and then seconds later takes a tripping penalty. Carolina shorthanded here. As we'll take a quick media timeout. 9 to go. Second period, 6-0, thanks to DeAndre. Power play coming up for Delaware, thanks to DeAndre. We'll be back in 30 seconds. Back to Winston-Salem. It's been an eventful 10 minutes for Vinny DeAndre. Assisted on Blake Peavy's second goal of the game. Scored his first goal since December of 2019. Made it a 6-0 game, and now he's in the box, two for tripping. Thunder to another power play here tonight. 5 seconds gone on the power play as Cosentino gives this one up for Daniel Martin as a centering feed. Cosentino coming in relief here of Trevor Babin. Babin, 6 goals on 22 shots, is back down the right side. It comes Alexei Arsenal. Thrown back in. Yuri Pestuka takes a hit there. All the way around, it's taken here. Laporte back in behind. One of the give and go. Talipov off the boards. All the way around, it comes past Daniel Martin. Delaware holds this one in. 8:22 to go. 6-0 hockey game. Thunderbirds down a man right now. Marker walks in and shoots one. Paul in the save. It hit him right in the crest. As now it's taken here by Dawson Baker. Looks up ice. Thunderbirds want a shorthanded rush. Baker and Martin say why not. Down the right side against Cosentino. Baker pulls up. Wants to look up top. Talipov, and he does. Goes back out into the neutral zone. And all the way back in. Talipov eating up as much clock on this penalty kill as he possibly could. Ryan Marker back through center. Throwing this one cross ice. Laporte looking up at that one. Settles it down. Finds the seam. Marker off the boards. Looking to get Delaware on the board in this one. Laporte far side at the hash marks. Away from some stick work by George Holt. Now it's around. Talipov is there. Clears the zone a second time. Bouncing puck is escapes Blake Peavy at center. Cosentino on his backhand. The goaltender plays it for Timothy Payne. 22 seconds left on the man advantage here for Delaware. Damo Asselin, now down the right side. Marker against Clouston. Sharp angle chance, wants the wrap chance. No dice there as a turnaround shot. Schnapp blocks it again. Jacob Schnapp's been giving up the body left and right this weekend. 5 seconds of the power play. Cosentino slams his stick on the ice. DeAndre almost out. Long shot there by Marker, knocked down on its way. Loose puck swept on goal. Paul in the save, where's the rebound? And there is none. Pucked up in Paulin's equipment somewhere. 6:55 to go. Second period. Thunderbirds kill it off. Delaware 0-4 on the power play so far tonight. Thunderbirds have had just 2 opportunities. Haven't found their way into the back of the net on the man advantage either. Shots 11-5 so far in this second period. 28-10 on the game is. Paulin kicks out another shot, and a follow-up chance is swept around in front. 2 big saves by the leg pads of Chris Paulin. Dimmitt gets this one back out for Cardinal. Outlet pass, John Batita back on the ice for the first time in a while. Tries to drop this through. Nice move by Clouston, waiting and throwing that one off the goalpost. Cosentino twisting around to try and keep that puck out. Down low, Batita tries to work it through. Taken back out by Delaware. Here comes Marker. Basket hanging. He's going to have a chance. One-on-one against Paulin. Wrap chance again. And the shot somehow stays out. Oh, did Chris Paulin get a paddle on that? If he did, it's a miraculous save. Tommy Cardinal back the other way now for Carolina. Cardinal in front for 4 to backhand chance. Cosentino the save. Collected here by Fliegel. Back out come the Thunder. Laporte. Marker wants it again. He thought he had a sure goal. Looked like a carbon copy of last night's tally for Marker. Instead, Paulin and Clouston come back and get the lumber on it, right as that puck was about ready to cross the goal line. 5:51 to go. Thunderbirds break it in. Batita finds a man. DeAndre the shot. He scores! Vinny DeAndre's got 2. 7-0 Thunderbirds. Vinny DeAndre joins the double club. DeAndre, Batita, and Peavy. Each of those with 2 goals tonight. Thunderbirds swinging away here. His third and fourth career FPHL goals. This one collected now here down the right side. Thunder have a bit of a gap here. Long shot sent there through the goal mouth and out the near side. John Batita with another assist in this hockey game. 5 points on the night for the Thunderbird captain. This one thrown back, Yuri Peshtuka gets this back up. Daniel Martin down the left side here. Through center, he's got DeAndre again. Down the right wing, drops it off for Martin. DeAndre back in deep. Chipped on the backhand here by Dawson Baker. It's collected and moved back out here. Arsenal stepped into there. Holt tries to find DeAndre. He's got two already tonight. Vinny DeAndre, the shot stopped by Cosentino. Shot fought off and Payne able to get this one back out through center. White near side, skated in two. A long shot stopped by Paul and he denies Michael Swiderski. Holt on the rebound, flips it back up to center. Settled down by Arsenal. In over the line. Thought the play was offsides. He'll pass it back. McNally is there. 4:40 to go. Thunderbirds kick the extra point. DeAndre makes it 7-0. Jacob Schnapp finds Daniel Martin now down the left side. Top of the circles, lets it go. Cosentino the save. Up top, Schnapp wanted to throw it up to a defenseman. It evades everybody, and the Thunderbirds, in the midst of a line change, have to come back as Paulin drops for Talipov. Long stretch pass here. Bounces in. No icing, and they'll rule it deflected off of one of the Thunder players in the neutral zone as Blake Peavy gets to work here. Two goals tonight. Finds Tucker. High slot. Shot saved by Cosentino. The rebound. Cleared back out to center. Clouston on it here. Thunderbirds end. Thunderbirds have put considerable amount of pucks in the back of the net, particularly against Delaware this season. 7 goals tonight. 4 last night was the fewest goal total, the lowest goal total, I should say, that the Thunderbirds have had against Delaware this season. A pair of 8-3 wins to open the campaign, 9-5 win up in Delaware at the end of December. 5 goals in an overtime loss, 4 last night, 7 tonight as Cardinal shoots one and he rang it off the goalpost. Tommy Cardinal, nearly an 8 spot right here. Tucker in front, Cardinal again. Down low behind the goal, wants to flip it up. Oh, he tried the Michigan, you could see it. I could read it on his face, he wanted to try it. Tommy Cardinal tried the lacrosse move. Puck rolled off his stick at the last second and Clouston thrown around Ryan Marker behind the goal. Away from Talipov, drops it off, long shot, kicked out by Paul and Laporte on the rebound. Marker collects in the right wing circle. 3 minutes to go, second period, Paul in a late save. The rebound steered away as Von Clouston head up, backhand pass, in behind Gus Ford, and he can't quite pick it up off the boards. Blows a tire, Cardinal threw a pass back that was intended for Clouston. He's on it here and throws it back for John Batita. Now here's a chance, Batita shoots that one off the outside of the goal. Almost a 6-point night there for the Thunderbird captain. 2 goals and 3 assists right now. That one thrown now down the right side for Clouston. Lucchese, long shot, fought off by Paul on the rebound. As the puck hit him up high, chopped out there by Clouston. Out to the far side, another kick save by Paulin. Marker tried to sneak one through at the last second there. Batita with 2.5 to go in the second period. Trying to dart his way through. Arsenal works it back and it's collected here. Michael Swiderski. 28-19 the shots right now. As here comes Swiderski with some more speed. Knifed away from him. Follow-up chance. Paulin the save. Rebound chopped back out. Settled down by Delaware. Dustin White a long chance. Something laying in Chris Paulin's goal crease right now. Might be the top end of a stick, the plug that goes in the handle. Ford now down the right side. DeAndre a chance, tried to send that one back through for John Batita. Vinny DeAndre on the top line right now with Batita and Ford as Dimmitt finds it down the right side now. Shot off the outside of the goal. Cameron Dimmitt now out to the left side. Throws it back down for Batita. Inside two to go. Backdoor feed DeAndre and he shanked it wide. Almost a chance at the HT. Arsenal throws it back up, and you know he's going to get a ton of ice time in the third. Now down the left side. Arsenal backdoor feed. A shot leaks through Paul, and they score. J.C. Moritz, Michael Swiderski teaming up there. 1:25 to go. It is 7-1. Delaware is on the board. Alexi Arsenal, first goal in a Thunder uniform. Spoils the shutout bid for Chris Paulin. 19 saves on 20 shots right now. Thunderbirds a bit frustrated with themselves on that one. Kind of that instance of the offense getting a little too excited there, but 7-1, you got a lot of goal, a lot of cushion there. This one thrown back in on Paul in minute 19 to go as he will cover this one up for defensive zone faceoff coming up here for the Thunderbirds. As with a minute 16 to go, we'll take that final media timeout here in this second period. 7-1, Delaware just cutting into the lead recently.
Sometimes we all need a bit of help. Come on.
Want to get in on the action? Bring your friends. With group packages of 12 seats or more, tickets start at just $12 a person. Group packages are perfect for church groups, youth groups, business outings, and more. Come together to see your Thunderbirds. Call 336-748-3949 today.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill. Relax.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem. Final minute 16 of this second period. Vinny DeAndre, first multi-goal game. Not quite as high as point total so far, though. Three assists in a December 2019 game against Battle Creek. 3 points right now, he ties it. 2 goals and a helper, and as Chris Paulin taking a bit of time to get back into his goal crease. Some adjustments with the equipment. Minute 16 to go. Hasn't been overly busy, but back-to-back nights for the Thunderbird goaltender. The minutes do kind of pile up as the season has gone on. 6-7-1 this year. Paulin over 600, coming up on 700 minutes played. The workhorse in the Carolina goal. Long shot through traffic. Delaware almost able to put another one on goal. As now Jacob Schnapp controls. Back out. One at Dawson Baker on the far side. Off the board, Sargis backhands that one through. Martin in front of the Delaware goal. Taken here by Schnapp, and he tries to advance it on for Martin. Puck skips past him. 2-on-1 coming. Dawson Baker, a chance alone. A shot, a save. And Jacob Schnapp, a hefty collision there as he was coming over the line with one of the Thunder defensemen. Dawson Baker, a huge chance. Wanted to go 5-hole on Cosentino. Shuts the door and gets down the paddle. Makes the save with 53.5 to go. Another face-off in the right-wing circle coming up here for Carolina. Blake Peavy, another one of those guys that's got 2 goals in this game already. Wins it back. Zach Sargis, unable to keep that puck in the zone as he throws that one off the boards. Reading it nicely was Michael Swiderski. And the puck back in Carolina territory. Peavy turns over his back shoulder. Throws it on around for Pestuka, who lets it go now for Dawson Baker as that chance rolls up on him. Check that, it was Jackson Tucker, and now it's Daniel Martin with Tucker breaking towards the goal. Tried to throw it in front. Tucker couldn't quite set up body position. Martin couldn't get the pass through. As Peavy throws it near side for Tucker. Wants to find Peavy, can't go back to him. Laporte, able to tip it past Tucker here. Heavy check there as Dustin White shoulders that one through. On and around it comes, bouncing puck. With the final 10 seconds here in the second period, 7-1 the score. Thunderbirds will take a hefty lead into the dressing room after 40 minutes of play. Paulin touches this one up, no icing. Time expires, 40 minutes in the books. 7 goals for Carolina, 2 for Batita, 2 for Peavy. 2 for DeAndre. A Dawson Baker power play goal nestled in there as well. And Baker very nearly had his second goal of the game on a breakaway chance after the Schnapp pass. Vinny DeAndre making a name for himself right here on the score sheet. 7-1 through 40 minutes. We'll be back in a moment here with the Pine Tree Tavern second intermission report. You are watching and listening to the Thunderbirds Hockey Network.
Sometimes, we all need a bit of help. Come on. That's where North Carolina Golf Academy comes in. Let me give you a little tip. With 4 instructors ready to get your game to the next level, we're open to the public. Practice on our fully lit driving range and gear up at our pro shop. We're a proudly licensed Callaway dealer.
Give us a call at 336-324-2374.
And visit us in High Point.
There you go. That's a bomb.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
So, it's time for a new truck. But you have this list of places to be and stuff to do. Between getting the groceries, going to work, and picking up the kids, finding time to buy a car seems so overwhelming. That's where Go Modern comes in. With Go Modern, buying a new vehicle is more flexible than ever. No guesswork, just buying and financing made easy. Visit the dealership to make sure you love it, or we'll deliver right to your door. With Go Modern, you're in control. Go Modern, the new way to experience the modern difference.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So, we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic. The Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, because these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or visit us at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Want to get in on the action? Bring your friends. With group packages of 12 seats or more, tickets start at just $12 a person. Group packages are perfect for church groups, youth groups, business outings, and more.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem on the Pine Tree Tavern. Second intermission report. 7-1. The score right now. Carolina firmly on top of the Delaware Thunder. And to be completely honest, not entirely sure what's going on the ice right now in this intermission report. We're doing things a little bit differently here. Again, with the storm and the weather as it is, the Thunderbirds are heavily short-staffed right now, so we're just kind of making it work right now. And so, again, a huge thank you out to all of the people who have put a ton of work into making this game happen tonight under some adverse circumstances. But 7-1 the score on the ice. Circumstances out there pretty favorable right now for Carolina. They walked into the second period with a 4-0 lead. A pair of John Batita shorthanded goals, a power play goal by Dawson Baker, and a Blake Peavy even strength goal. Had him out to a pretty comfortable lead, and then Peavy would come back with another goal of his own. After his deflection, heavy wrist shot beats the goaltender. And then Vinny DeAndre, a pair of back-to-back goals. Alexei Arsenault would break through with his first goal in a Thunder uniform. Taking the goose egg off the board there for Chris Paulin, but really not a ton to say about this one. It's pretty clear the way this game has gone. The Thunderbirds, it's not really structure right now. I mean, you see the lines are being thrown all together. You got DeAndre out there with Ford and Batita. We didn't see John Batita for quite some time in that second period. Not sure exactly how the lines will shake out here in the third. You saw some more of Jackson Tucker, and now is the time to try and get those guys who don't see a ton of ice time that chance. And it's not just, you know, oh, the score is 7-1, let's throw out just anybody. It's a situation where you never know who you're going to need down the stretch. When playoffs roll around and there are injuries and there are no asterisks, like, oh, well, they lost this playoff game, but hey, they had a ton of guys hurt, no big deal. That doesn't matter. You know, all that goes up on the score sheet is the result. And so if you can get more guys playing more ice time during the season, and you go back down the stretch at the end of the year and you need someone to slot into the lineup, like a DeAndre, like a Jackson Tucker, you'd rather have them have played quite a few more minutes and get some more confidence via goal scoring and assist getting than you would have them sit in the stands and not participate at all and not get any of those reps. So they kind of make a favorable situation here, even more favorable for the Thunderbirds as they continue to work things out here against the Delaware Thunder. 7-1 the score through the first 40 minutes of this hockey game. We're going to take you to a quick break, and when we come back, take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard and the road ahead for the Carolina Thunderbirds in a pretty lopsided 7-1 hockey game here from Winston-Salem. We'll be back with that and more on the Pine Tree Tavern second intermission report.
The Carolina Thunderbirds have a set of two custom wine labels that can be yours to take home today. The Thunderbirds Red and Carolina White are special edition, first-run custom wine labels for Carolina Thunderbirds fans. Bottles are $40 individually and $75 when bought as a set. Call the Thunderbirds office to get yours today. 336-774-4625.
Conveniently located at the corner of Rinalda Road and Northwest Boulevard, Salem Smiles and Dr. Sarah C. Schoaf is the preferred orthodontist of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Dr. Schoaf is a Winston-Salem native and a trusted name in orthodontics since 1992. So whether you're on the ice or in the stands, trust your teeth to Dr. Smashmouth and her team at Salem Smiles.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic, the Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, because these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or visit us at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Sometimes, we all need a bit of help. Come on! That's where North Carolina Golf Academy comes in.
Let me give you a little tip.
With four instructors ready to get your game to the next level, we're open to the public. Practice on our fully lit driving range and gear up at our pro shop. We're a proudly licensed Callaway dealer. Give us a call at 336-884-4653 and visit us in High Point.
There you go. That's a bomb.
Want to get in on the action? Bring your friends. With group packages of 12 seats or more, tickets start at just $12 a person. Group packages are perfect for church groups, youth groups, business outings, and more. Come together to see your Thunderbirds. Call 336-748-3949 today.
Sometimes,
welcome back to Winston-Salem. Thunderbirds 7-1 right now over the Delaware Thunder. Not the only game going on in the FPHL tonight. Pretty lopsided in Watertown as well. It was 4-1. It began lopsided, I should say. 4-1 as we visited that last time in the first intermission. 5-1 at one point, and as we refresh the page, 6-3 right now. Watertown over Binghamton on the road again. First place team in the FPHL having their way with a scrappy Black Bears squad. Again, just trying to maintain themselves in the playoff picture. Fourth place right now. Kind of going back and forth here over the last little bit. 6-3 final score there. McDonald and company having their way with the Black Bears. And again, Columbus and Port Huron, they'll go toe-to-toe later on this afternoon, or this evening, I should say. And again, Danbury, the only team without a dance partner right now. It's been an interesting stretch of games for the Danbury Hattricks. 16 wins so far on the season. Kind of hanging about right now, and the Thunderbirds will have to get ready again for them, and it'll be an emotional game for sure. Again, both two of the three overtime losses for the Thunderbirds this season came at the hands of the Danbury Hattricks. Both of those games here at home. This will be the first time the Thunderbirds travel up north to visit the Hattricks, building that they've had some trouble playing in Danbury. The only team in 2019-2020 that the Thunderbirds actually had a losing record against. Just recently trying to pull that all-time series back up to a favorable point there. The all-time matchup between Carolina and Danbury. A little slanted in Danbury's favor over the last little bit. One more quick break in the Pine Tree Tavern. Second intermission report. We'll set the stage for not exactly a dramatic third period, but a third period. 7-1 the score. We'll be back in a moment.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic. The Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, because these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or visit us at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Want to get in on the action? Bring your friends. With group packages of 12 seats or more, tickets start at just $12 a person. Group packages are perfect for church groups, youth groups, business outings, and more. Come together to see your Thunderbirds. Call 336-748-3949 today.
For generations, people have trusted the modern dealerships to make a difference when they buy a new or used vehicle. Now there's a new way to experience the modern difference. It's called Go Modern, and it puts you in control. You can do everything from choosing your vehicle to scheduling home delivery completely online. Or just do the parts you want and finish at one of our 17 dealerships. Go Modern is car buying when you want, where you want, and how you want. And it's the new way to experience the modern difference.
Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist helps you do more of the things you love. More laughs, more adventures, more hugs. We combine the brightest minds in medicine to bring you world-class care with a commitment to strengthen the health and wellness of our community. Because when it comes to the health of you and your family, no one should settle for anything short of life-changing.
Family-owned and operated since 1938, Mustin and Crutchfield Food Market in Kernersville is the place to find your favorite homemade foods. Sample the finest cuts of meat from our on-site butcher, enjoy a glass bottle of soda like the old days, and go home with a tub of our famous homemade pimento cheese. Come see us at 245 North Main Street in downtown Kernersville.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem for the last time on the Pine Tree Tavern. Second intermission report, 7-1 Thunderbirds to this point in the hockey game. 5 points on the night for John Batita. And multiple players with two goals. Blake Peavy, one of them. And he'll look to be out there for a long stretch of time, most likely starting out here in this third period. Peavy, one of those players that when you get him going, really does kind of find that extra gear. And one of the Thunderbirds' more reliable and dependent second, third line centers. As the season has gone on, Peavy probably going to be the player to look out for in this third period. He and Jacob Schnapp have been getting pretty close to goals. Schnapp hasn't been able to break through yet on the weekend. Keep an eye on number 6 in black as the Thunderbirds get back out on the ice here. And for Chris Paulin, just staying in it mentally, not falling asleep at the wheel. Nothing really he could do about that most recent Thunder goal, the only one on the board right now. 19 saves on 20 shots at this point in the hockey game. Paulin just needs to keep playing the way he has been, and the Thunderbirds should be all set to go here as they get set for the third period. That'll do it for the Pine Tree Tavern second intermission report. Another break, and when we come back, third period coming your way from Winston-Salem on a snowy Sunday night matchup.
Sometimes, we all need a bit of help. Come on. That's where North Carolina Golf Academy comes in.
Let me give you a little tip.
With four instructors ready to get your game to the next level, we're open to the public. Practice on our fully lit driving range and gear up at our pro shop. We're a proudly licensed Callaway dealer.
Give us a call at 336-324-2374.
And visit us in High Point.
There you go. That was a bomb.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
So, it's time for a new truck. But you have this list of places to be and stuff to do. Between getting the groceries, going to work, and picking up the kids, finding time to buy a car seems so overwhelming. That's where Go Modern comes in. With Go Modern, buying a new vehicle is more flexible than ever. No guesswork, just buying and financing made easy. Visit the dealership to make sure you love it, or we'll deliver right to your door. With Go Modern, you're in control. Go Modern, the new way to experience the modern difference.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So, we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
After the success of the...
Welcome back for third period action here. Thunderbirds going to work here against the Delaware Thunder. A 7-1 hockey game. Carolina watches Ryan Marker play this one back into his own end. Cosentino in goal now for the Thunder. Dabbing out with about 9 minutes to go in the second period. DeAndre chased him about midway through the game as Daniel Martin now down the left side finds one in front for Jacob Schnapp. Following on is Dawson Baker. Out of the left wing circle, Baker doubles back. Makes a couple of spins there. A few revolutions around the left wing faceoff circle, but now it's up back the other way. Marker against Jacob Schnapp. Marker trying to drive wide again. Favoring that wraparound chance. He's added a number of times in this game. And Chris Paulin and Von Clausen came back with the sticks. Make sure that puck didn't cross the goal line. Marker seemed to have had a pretty good opportunity. Almost had a certain goal on that last chance. Cosentino gloves this one down. Throws it back in. Delaware shipping it back in. A heavy collision just inside the Thunderbird blue line. Talipov going shoulder to shoulder with Steven Fliegel. Thunder move it back up top. Timothy Payne off a couple of legs. Ramil Talipov on this one. Throws this one cross ice, batted out of the air. Ryan Marker got a stick on that one. Disrupts the pass. And so it's Payne back in here for the Thunder. Payne throws it in front. Marker the shot. Stopped by Paulin. Came out to cut down the angle. It worked out for him. DeAndre on with Cardinal and Blake Peavy. Cardinal hits the blue line. Roll back in away from Laporte. And behind the goal, Peavy backtracking now. Payne skates this one back out to center here for Delaware. Feeds a pass. Swiderski tries to drop it over. Laporte, a shot stopped by Paul. And rebound. Oh, he made the second save, too, as his mask was coming off. A couple of quick opportunities here for Paulin. Or for Delaware, rather. Paulin making the saves. Paulin not a fan of that chance. It's got to be pretty scary, right, as the mask is coming off. The second shot comes in. So not only are you unprotected, but you've got your mask kind of restricting your vision. And Paulin's going to take a second here and fix the rest of his equipment. 1:50 gone here in this third period. It's brought to you by Newco Motors. 35-21, the shots on goal right now for Carolina. We're still going to wait a little bit here. Paulin back now to his skates. Played a lot of hockey over the last little while. Jacob Caffrey waiting on the bench. Thunderbirds backup goaltender tonight. Looks to stay with the team for the next little bit here again. Carolina waiting on the return of goaltender Nick Modica. The plan at the beginning of the season was kind of a 1A, 1B situation. Paulin and Modica giving the Thunderbirds one of the better goaltending combinations in the FPHL. Injuries had some other ideas. Dawson Baker now down the left wing with Gus Ford. Baker on the top line with Ford and Petita. Sargis down low. Baker on for Ford. Tries to spin in behind the goal, and now it's Swiderski. Able to chug this one back ahead here for the Thunder. Hits the blue line, Swiderski. Forced wide by Peshduka. Out of that far side corner, Peshduka gets after it there. Puck pulled off the goal skirt by Zach Sargis. Moved up to John Petita. He's got a lot of room to skate here. Thunderbird captain cuts parallel to the blue line. A pass. Baker wants to go back in front. Petita, a backdoor chance. Oh, Gus Ford almost able to stretch out and tap that one in. Bouncing puck past Gus Ford. Thrown up past Ryan Marker now. George Holt back and skating in his own end. 17:03 to go. Third period. 7-1 thanks to most recently Vinny DeAndre for the Thunderbirds, but Alexei Arsenault got the goose egg off the board for Delaware. Now it's Cameron Dimmitt. In over the line, Dimmitt pulls up and shoots one. Boy, that didn't miss by much, and it had a ton of speed behind it. A quick release from Cameron Dimmitt. This one thrown back out by DeAndre. It was knocked down, and Cardinal tries to spin a pass through. Check that Blake Peavy. And now back it comes down the left wing. Thrown in front without a glove. Timothy Payne, a shot stopped by Paulin. Payne without a glove on his bottom hand, still trying to work his way through with the puck. Stick lifted by Martin. Got to be careful there, the unprotected hand of Timothy Payne, as Holt moves it up here for Martin. Lucchese takes a man down. One of the Thunderbirds goes awkwardly into the boards. It was Peavy. Stepped on a stick, and Lucchese has it back out here with 16:13 to go in the third. Marker past Cameron Dimmitt. Rolls it in front of Chance Swiderski. On, he scores! Ryan Marker finds Swiderski wide open on the back door. Good vision there through the seam, and it's 7-2. Mike Swiderski, his second goal of the season. And the Thunderbirds have certainly a bit less of a jump in their steps right now. The game not in jeopardy, but you can kind of see the Thunder taking advantage of some lackadaisical play in the defensive zone here by Carolina. 3-1, they lead it here in the third. Finally broken through, it's Swiderski. Now back in come the Thunderbirds. Jacob Schnapp, a chance, a shot, and a save by Cosentino. Rebound kicked aside as well. He had Cardinal bearing down, and now Dawson Baker back out. Baker, near side, Schnapp throws it through. Here's a chance. Dawson Baker lets it go, and he scores! Dawson Baker gets it back. Second of the night, 8-1 Thunderbirds. Dawson Baker down the left side. A heavy shot goes between the wickets there on Cosentino. 8-2. Baker's second of the game. This one at even strength. So the Thunderbirds waste no time. Get it right back. Flex the offense's muscles some more. As Talipov goes D-to-D with Von Clouston. Back on top here. The deficit is 6 once again. Petita throws it across now for Vinny DeAndre. Back on the top line here with Petita and Ford as this one comes back. Marker sees that one come past him into the offensive zone. Lucchese goes awkwardly into the boards with Talipov. Nobody any worse for wear on that one. Lucchese a little slow getting back up as Gus Ford has that pass from Vinny DeAndre a little too far in front of him. Ford on it now. Goes up past Petita. Marker all over this one here for Delaware. Out to the far side. Thunder break in. Marker wants the drop pass. It's too far behind him. Here's a chance for Petita. Wants the home run pass for Ford. It was on and off his tape. Would have sent him in alone as Ford throws it in front. Petita! Oh, a glove save. Cosentino. John Petita thought he had the hat trick going there as Cosentino dumps it out. We'll keep going. Swiderski through center. Almost intercepted by Cardinal. 14:38 to go here in the third. Stick lift by Peavy. Denies Swiderski a good offensive chance. Now Batista swings back deep in his own end. Crossing center end. Cardinal stomps up at the blue line. Batita down the right side. Wants to lower the shoulder and go in around behind the goal. Pocket picked by a pair of Thunder players. Puck dislodged. Cardinal wants to get it through to Peavy. A shot, a punch save there by Cosentino. Got the blocker on that one. Peavy looking for his third of the hockey game. Ryan Marker throws this one up. It's gloved down by Pestuka. Zach Sargis. Puck rolls free around to the near side. Going back out through center and off the boards it comes right in front of the Thunderbirds goal. Thunderbirds bench, rather. This one thrown ahead, no icing. Cosentino out to play it. Kind of waves the stick. Peavy is in after it. Martin there as well. 13:53 to go here in the third. 8-2. Dawson Baker gets the Thunderbirds back out ahead by six. Down the right side, Swiderski. Away from George Holt, Ryan Marker here. And we've got a penalty coming. 13:40. 8-2 the score. We'll take a quick media timeout, and when we come back, we'll find out what the infraction is. 30 seconds and we're back on the Thunderbirds Hockey Network. Welcome back to Winston-Salem, 8-2 with 13:40 to go. Looks as though the Thunderbirds will find themselves on the power play. Roseboom in the penalty box here for Delaware. It seemed as though there was a missed call that Roseboom wasn't a fan of behind the play. He may have gotten a stick up high and out of frustration threw down the helmet. And the officials will take none of that, it would seem. Roseboom in the box. Carolina on its third power play chance here. Gone 0-for so far. And his back out it comes Von Clouston. 8-2 hockey game. Thunderbirds trying to break it back out. All the way back it comes in. Icing is called. Thunderbirds getting a bit out of sorts as they hit the line. Roseboom, the official booking is a delay of game call. Took his helmet off. 13:21 to go in the frame. A rare defensive zone face-off on the power play here for Carolina. It's Ford to take it. Extends his scoring streak with an assist tonight. He's now back through center. Clouston will just have to button hook back, and it's George Holt now working his way out of his own end. Lucchese steals it from him. Holt having some trouble here in the defensive zone. Thunderbirds will just set it up. DeAndre breaks it out here with Clouston. An assist here, Von Clouston. Back through center, tries to toe drag his way through. That won't work. And now back through it comes, cleared the length of the ice. Chris Paulin out of his goal to stop it. Marker and Roseboom getting the assists on the most recent Delaware goal. Swiderski is now here comes Dawson Baker weaving his way through on the power play. Baker, full head of steam, two goals already. A shot hit the goalpost. Rebound is loose, Cosentino. Trying to dive back, and here comes Delaware back the other way shorthanded. 49 seconds to go. Marker against Talipov. Good stick work there by the Thunderbird defenseman. Reaching in and prying that puck off the tape of Marker. 12:18 to go, third period. Yuri Pestuka able to work it free. Ramil Talipov guides it nicely up to Cameron Dimmitt. The puck leaks through him. Back out at center. Another shorthanded chance. Marker down the left side and snaps one. It catches the glass in behind Paulin. On the rebound, Laporte. Tries to throw it back out for Asselin, and it goes all the way back down. Cosentino there to stop it. All the way back across now. Laporte through center, shorthanded. 7 seconds to go on the Thunderbird power play. Holt trying to catch him in the middle of a line change. Here comes Jacob Schnapp. Pulls it away from a diving defenseman, and his shot goes wide. Undressed Timothy Payne, and out of the box now is Roseboom. Delaware kills it off. Thunderbirds still without a power play goal since the Dawson Baker one. Now it moves back through. Clouston, a shot kicked out by Cosentino. Timothy Payne on it here. Out of his defensive zone. 11:21 to go. Thunderbirds lead it 8-2.
All the way back around it comes. No icing. George Holt is here. Plays it away on his back end there from Roseboom. Holt from the goal line. Steers it across Von Clouston. In front of his own bench, Thunderbirds get a partial line change. Clouston trying to weave through everybody, gets his pocket picked. And Ryan Marker says thank you very much. Here at Rutledge, some extra instruction for his defenseman on the bench. Nick Modica acting as kind of an assistant coach tonight, as he has been for the last stretch of games. Modica injured in the first Danbury series. Lower body injuries, he went down to make a save. Still in the recovery process from that. We'll look to see perhaps Modica back soon. Well, it's tough to say with these types of injuries. No firm timetable. Martin back the other way here with Petita. Almost a two-on-one. Snakes it through. Petita can't pull it to the backhand. Almost the HT for the Thunderbird captain. McNally away here from Martin here. Those two come together. The near side corner. Three Thunder and two Thunderbirds. Now able to work it one out. Daniel Martin. Taken into the boards, throws it up top. Pestuka winds, fires. That one goes wide off the boards. Enthusiastic bounce there off the Zamboni door. Thunderbirds almost had for themselves a nice little carom pass off the backboards. Inside 10 to go. Newco Motors third period. Thunderbirds an 8-2 lead here. Baker's second of the night has gotten us the 8 spot. Yuri Pestuka from out behind the Thunderbirds goal. John Petita gives it back to him. Sargis. Lots of passes out for the Thunderbirds here. Petita tried to pull up and hit the far side winger. It was Jacob Schnapp. Deflected off the stick of White. Delaware now moving D to D. Back it comes Swiderski. Runs into Yuri Pestuka. Throws it across for Schnapp. Sidestepping Laporte now gaining the line. Petita can't pull that puck out of his own skates. Laporte. Steals and goes back the other way. Intercepted nicely by Zach Sargis. Head up, wants to move into the offensive zone with it and does. Here comes Zach Sargis towards the goal. Almost a chance there. Sargis spun out in that left wing corner. And he chugs back up to his point spot. And Delaware will wind things back up from their own end. Long stretch of games here for the Thunder. And these two teams will meet again in February. It's an interesting part of the schedule there is this one all the way back down, no icing into the Thunderbirds' end. The 1-4-4 Thunderbirds play four games in 4 days. They go back to back to back to back. One game in Danbury on a Thursday, then Friday, Saturday, Sunday up in Delaware. That'll round out the season series between these two clubs. Dawson Baker trying to work with it out of that far side corner. Mukasey now back through center for Delaware. In over the line, long shot. That didn't miss by much. It goes past the blocker side of Paulin. Past the goal post, and Laporte goes after Cameron Dimmitt. Puck rolls free. He and Dimmitt have some words for each other behind the play. As now PV rolls this on for DeAndre. Inside eight to go. Newco Motors third period. Those two head for the bench. Timothy Payne muscled into there by Dawson Baker. Taken back out. Payne on through center. Down the left side, Laporte. Marker, one of the backdoor feed, long shot, and that one deflects up out of play and lands in the netting. 7:41 left, third period, 8-2 Carolina. Take another media timeout on the Thunderbirds Hockey Network. Welcome back to Winston-Salem. We're headed down the stretch here. 40 shots on goal for the Thunderbirds so far tonight. 23 for Delaware, an 8-2 hockey game. Thunderbirds firmly in front on this one, and they look to button things up here with some strong defensive play. They allowed a pair of Delaware goals to get them back into it. Dawson Baker put Carolina into the back of the net one more time. And all was right with the world as Daniel Martin moves this one back out through center. Hits the line with Petita and Cardinal. Martin swinging out wide. Left-handed shot, works it back up top. Quick little pass, give and go with George Holt. Was he able to keep it in? No. Holt brought the puck out back over the blue line. Offsides it comes, and face-off coming outside the zone. 7:18 to go here in this third period. Hopefully the last time we'll have to deal with this kind of snowy situation here in Winston-Salem. After the highest capacity crowd so far this season last night, 31-32, on hand to witness the Saturday night victory by Carolina. And don't have the official attendance sheet in front of me right now. It may be just a hair below that at this current time as the Thunderbirds, Tommy Cardinal down the right side. Cardinal pulls up in the right wing circle. Near side, Talapov. Thrown in front, a chance, a shot. Cardinal, what a save by Cosentino. Rebound, Talapov, kicked out by Cosentino again. Rebound, Martin off the outside of the goal, and Cosentino pounces on top of that for a faceoff. 6:38 to go. In all seriousness, it's probably for the best that many of you watching and listening at home stayed home tonight. Not that we don't want to see you here, but we want to see everybody safe and sound, and the roads quite difficult to travel right now. Personally, had to spend a considerable amount of time on I-40 coming to the rink today, and that drive took two or three times as long as it normally does. So at the end of the day, what's important is that everybody stays safe in some adverse weather conditions here. As Delaware tries to chug this puck out from their own end, Lucchese in over the line, down the left wing. Knifed away from him by Zach Sargis. Lucchese out of the right wing corner. Sargis takes control of that one and finds Yuri Peshtuka. Thrown back out by Dawson Baker, or off of Dawson Baker. Now it's poked back free, a chance for Peavy. 2-on-1 with DeAndre. Fakes the shot, pulls up and shoots it, and it's blocked off the leg of Flago. Back out to center it comes. Dimmitt on it here from the Thunderbird blue line. Lofts that one end over end. Bouncing puck settled down here by Timothy Payne. Near side, kicked that there by Swiderski. And now back out through center. Settled down here off the tape of Lucchese, all the way back in, and an icing will be called here. 5:40 to go in the third period, brought to you by Newco Motors. And how ironic would it have been if the hockey game played on a sheet of ice had to be canceled because there was too much snow and ice outside. Not to say it hasn't happened before, but Petita now to take the offensive zone draw here with four. Puck is dropped. Tommy Cardinal from up high throws it across. Near side, Talapong. Long shot, punched out by Cosentino. Rebound settled down by Petita into the slot. Pocket picked. Here's a chance. Cardinal. High slot, sidesteps Laporte, waiting and shooting it. It goes through the crease off the boards, and Talapov takes it there, the one-time drive. Hit Gus Ford up high and rolls free. Puck thrown back out, a bouncer taken by Talapov. From the red line, D-to-D with Dimmitt. Off the boards, Petita drops it back, 2-on-1. Cardinal with Ford, delays, throws it over to Ford, and it's broken up on its way back through. Nice defensive play there. It looked like Tim Payne may have gotten a touch on that one. 5:03 to go, an 8-2 hockey game. Thunderbirds seeing some favorable results while wearing the blackout jerseys here for the first two times. Gus Ford intercepts it, high slot, waits, has a lane, goes back door, a shot, a big stop by Cosentino. He denies Cardinal. Second of, I believe, four nights that the Thunderbirds will wear these jerseys this season. And again, that jersey sale is open right now on the Thunderbirds website, only for a limited time, though I believe it'll end at 5 p.m. Monday night. So if you want to get yourself an authentic Thunderbirds jersey, you best hurry, because it's not going to be open for very much longer. Supplies are limited. Ryan Marker through center now. Ford throws an extra little bump there to McNally. 4:20 left in this third period, 8-2. Ryan Marker now down the right side, wants the wraparound chance. I've seen that one before. Cameron Dimmitt knifes it away. On his backhand, off the glass, settles down into the skates of Dawson Baker. Lays down in a follow-up chance by DeAndre. That one stung Stephen Fliego as he blocked it. Now Schnapp has it down out of the left-wing corner. Baker lets it go. Another shot and another block by Fliego. Boy, oh boy. Two tough breaks for him. Meant to block the first one. The second one just wrong place at the wrong time. Makes the block. Got to commend him for a solid effort there. And good for Fliego. He gets back to the bench. Jacob Schnapp had a similar shift in last night's contest. As Pestuka chugs this one back out. John Batita back through center. Down the left side, slips a check. It was Payne. Batita pulls up and throws it up across. George Holt a shot. In on goal and a save by Cosentino. 3:24 to go, third period. Final media timeout of the third. 30 seconds and we'll be back on the Thunderbirds Hockey Network. Offensive zone draw coming up here for the Thunderbirds. It is Daniel Martin winning it back, and it comes back out. Yuri Pestuka chasing it. Lucchese going to have a chance here against Chris Paulin. A shot. Paulin makes the save. Rebound swept on here behind the goal. Marker hits the breaks away from George Holt. 3:11 to go in the third period, and back out. Here it comes. John Batita. Two goals, three assists tonight. Batita trying to sidestep Timothy Payne. Gives him a little extra bit of a chop as he goes by. Rebound taken back here. Laporte off at the late offsides, has to let the puck go. Talipov, now a chance. Daniel Martin to the goal, sweeps it on there. Saved by Cosentino. Oh, and he poked it away. John Batita was right there, and Talipov's shot gets blocked. Thunderbirds circling for more here. Cosentino's made a number of great saves. Talipov throws it back down into the skates of Gus Ford. Away from Payne on his backhand, steps out. Still working his way through some of the traffic. Ford spins, wants to drop this one through for Talipov. Saucer pass, and now a turnaround shot by Martin, gloved and held. Cosentino hangs on for a faceoff. 2:25 to go. Been a back-and-forth month for the Thunderbirds. 2-5-1 here in the month of January. Looking to get back on the right side of things. Stringing together a couple of wins. Every team in the FPHL is streakless right now. There were some streaks that were snapped. Everybody has either lost one or won one, and that's as far back as the streak goes. The only other team that is safe from that is the Watertown Wolves, and they're on an 11-game winning streak. 12, I believe, now at the conclusion of the Binghamton game as Pestuka cranks one off the glass over the head of Cosentino, and he makes another save as Jacob Schnapp deflects one right in front of him. And Schnapp looks as though he can't really buy a goal right now, and it's just tough to see because he's had so many great chances in this game and in last night's hockey game. Again, Jacob Schnapp, third on the team in scoring, really come into his own as one of the premier offensive players for Carolina. 19 points in his limited Thunderbirds career so far. As we hit the two-minute warning here, Schnapp, two assists so far in this hockey game. Can't find the back of the net himself, though. Settle for two assists, I believe. This one rolls in on Cosentino, and he'll block it away. Been a bit of a goal-scoring drought for Jacob Schnapp over the last little bit. Four games without a goal. And that came after a five-game scoring streak from New Year's Eve all the way back to January the 8th. And now back comes through center. Another chance for the Thunderbirds. Nice move there by Baker. He tried to put it to the forehand between the wickets. Cosentino makes the save. Minute 22 to go, third period. 8-2 Thunderbirds. Now another chance. Baker, high slot. Two goals. This one kicked back on. And out of the corner, it's in behind the goal now. Delaware able to take control of this one. Four Thunderbirds with a pair of goals tonight. Peavy Baker, DeAndre Batita. There's a hefty collision there. Jacob Schnapp as we hit the final minute of play here in this third period. Again, the Thunderbirds get set to turn their attention to Columbus. It'll be a very different looking game as here comes Ryan Marker. 3-on-1, look out. Marker's shot, stopped by Paulin, makes the save, and he gets dumped there by Zach Sargent. Paulin, not a fan of that play. Chris Paulin the victim of a late odd man rush here. Forced to make a pretty good save and dive out on the rebound, and just poor timing as Sargis comes back and almost trips over Paulin. Gets the stick up under the helmet of the goaltender as well. Those two will certainly shake hands and make up in the locker room afterwards. 10 Thunderbird forwards with a point right now. Only six who have not found the score sheet in this hockey game. 37 seconds, a chance on the far side. Goalpost goes wide off of the stick of Laporte. From the point it goes into the shin guards of John Batita. Back up top it comes. Fligo, a drive up and over the shoulder of Paulin. Off the glass now, Ryan Marker. Spun out by Cameron Dimmitt. Final 21 seconds. He'll go to work against John Batita in the corner, and Delaware pretty insistent on trying to find the back of the net one more time here. They've gotten some good chances. Up top, Timothy Payne winds and blocks the shot there. It's gloved and held by Chris Paulin. He wanted to go for a skate there. 10.5 to go, just trying to run out the clock. Payne blasted it. Petito was in the way trying to block the shot. As Paulin having a talking to now from one of the officials. 10.5 to go. Long shot. Save goes wide. It seemed as though Paulin wanted them to continue the clock, as now Talipov goes into the boards. It all comes out in the wash. Time expires. 8-2 final score. Thunderbirds with back-to-back wins. 7 out of a possible 9 points on the weekend. When you take a step back and look at it, not a bad result at all. It's just the way the weekend started out. The Thunderbirds seem to have 3 points. A crushing overtime loss, and they respond with two pretty demonstrative victories here on home ice in front of their fans. 8-2 the final. We'll send you to a quick break, and then we'll put a button on this one, and then we'll try to get out of here safely back to our homes through the snow. 8-2. We'll be back in a moment with the post-game show.
The Carolina Thunderbirds wanted to make it even easier to stay up to date on your favorite team. So, we brought the team right onto your home screen. Introducing the Carolina Thunderbirds app, presented by Campus Gas. It's the best way to see the latest content, rosters, and standings. Take a look at the team's schedule, and at the push of a button, buy your tickets. Head over to the App Store and download today.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill. Relax by our pool and cabana. Gear up at the Pro Shop and sharpen your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green. And play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. Find out more at MapleChaseCC.com.
So it's time for a new car, but where do you go? You could go here, or you could go here. Seriously? Nobody does that anymore. We thought there has to be a better way to buy a car. Where you do it, when you want, where you want, and how you want. So we made one. It's called Go Modern. We made it easy to choose a car you want. Pick your payment, apply for credit, even schedule home delivery. Or just do some of that and finish the rest at one of our 17 dealerships, the way you always have. Go Modern. The new way to experience the modern difference.
The Carolina Thunderbirds have a set of two custom wine labels that can be yours to take home today. The Thunderbirds Red and Carolina White are special edition, first-run custom wine labels for Carolina Thunderbirds.
Welcome back to Winston-Salem as we button things up here. 8-2 final score, the Carolina Thunderbirds over the Delaware Thunder. Yet again this season, they improve 7-0-0-1 all-time against the Thunder. Another win here in the books, and it was pretty much all said and done from the very beginning. A pair of shorthanded goals by John Batita. Delaware couldn't really recover from that. The Thunderbirds scored more goals shorthanded than they did power play tallies tonight. Dawson Baker's power play goal, the only such goal in tonight's contest. Blake Peavy a pair of goals. Vinny DeAndre a pair of goals. Arsenal and Swiderski would break through with the Delaware goals, make things a bit closer and give the Thunderbirds just enough of a scare that Dawson Baker would come back with another goal later in the third period. Our Barnola, three stars of tonight's game. Just a little late getting back from commercial. Couldn't get you back in to see him. But Chris Paulin, third star of tonight's contest. 21 saves on 23 shots, a 9-13 save percentage. Second star, Vinny DeAndre, two goals and an assist. Matches a career-high 3 points in tonight's game. And first star, you guessed it, John Batita. Two goals, three assists, 5 points in tonight's contest. 17 goals on the season now. He's catching up there. He and Gus Ford are neck and neck. Ford continued the point streak tonight with an assist. Now at 14 games, Gus Ford has scored in 14 consecutive contests. Doesn't get the goal, but the streak is alive, and for the Thunderbirds, they've put together a little mini streak of their own. Two straight wins for the Thunderbirds, points in three straight games. So things looking up a little bit around here. Carolina gets set for the Columbus River Dragons, second in the FPHL right now, their fiercest rival. Already played a number of games against the River Dragons this season that were not short of controversy, emotion, physicality, goal scoring, whatever you want it. It was available in those River Dragons games, and such will be the case in this upcoming weekend series again. That just about does it for us here at the Thunderbirds Hockey Network. For all of you that tuned in this weekend, thank you so much for listening and for watching. 8-2 final score. Good night, Carolina. We'll see you next time.